And welcome back to Forged by Geeks playing Gloomhaven. Haven't quite decided where we're going yet. We'll figure that out. But everything's looking pretty good overall. Couple quick updates for those watching. One, we mostly read through the fact this time. So we're really hoping that we will get a few more rules right.
Oh, we're going to get even more wrong. So.
Oh, probably.
Let's go.
But overall, we're having fun playing the game, and that's going well. The other thing is we're going to try something, so we're swapping out the HP tracking to using our prototype minis from our game, Defense Grid, the board game. We're hoping that'll make the HP a little bit more visible to all of us around the table in general, except for maybe Rico, because he'll be looking right at the stands. And we'll see how that goes. Let us know what you think as well, and if that works pretty good. Other than that, I'm Anthony.
Why am I shuffling this deck?
I don't know.
You want to for some odd
and
reason.
You are?
I'm Nicole, and I'm an idiot.
Got Rico over there, and got Peter playing Spock.
Live long and prosper.
How did I do that? Really?
Oh, yeah, we don't have to need to shuffle those. I think it's habit. You have cards if you want to shuffle.
I'm just, like, sitting here shuffling the deck.
Okay, so Rico was saying he knows pretty much what we've got to do next.
No,
so
we can either go to number three.
Mm-hmm.
Or number four. Before we decide to go there, we can choose to do a city event or not.
Yeah. Also, we did look at number 64, and it has a requirement of something called water breathing, which we don't have. So we're not going there.
We are also in town, so you guys can spend some of your hard-earned loot.
Oh, right.
To buy equipment if you so choose.
I want to spend 10 and get the iron helmet if no one has an objection.
What, it's your money, man. Yeah.
No, there's only two available.
Okay. All right.
So that does play a role. All
right. Will that interfere with your goggles at all?
No. Yes, it would. Yes, I cannot buy that and have the goggles.
Okay.
Good catch.
There you go.
Okay, I'm not getting that. Can you only have one bag item as well, or?
It depends on the level. I can't remember where I saw it. You can only have two small items, so two potions.
Okay.
And then one of each equipment type, so only one boot, one armor,
two-handed
weapon.
Max number of small items, half of a character level rounded up.
So
you can have one small item.
Oh, okay, so I'm not getting our potion.
No.
One head, one body, one leg. One max, one two-handed or two one-handed.
Ah. Okay, I see. Then I'm probably not going to buy anything. Would anybody else like to consider acquiring new loot?
Yes.
Yeah, I'd like to look at the deck.
Okay, cool.
And we will unlock more once we hit prosperity level 2.
Oh, which we have 3 more checks in order to hit.
So.
Oh, one other thing I found out. We were supposed to be marking off the locations as we completed them. So I've got a red marker somewhere I was using. And I marked off the 2 we already completed. Not a big deal, but...
Where are we supposed to record that? In the
town
book?
No, they get marked here.
No.
So there's a little square on them that you fill
in. No, that's what that little square is for.
Yeah, so you fill those in. Right. So we can't go back and just loot a place that we're good with.
I'd like to buy something, but nothing really grabs me out of the deck.
Yeah, that's kind of how I was feeling. And I know there's a big deck of stuff we still haven't unlocked. Oh, also, they've got a new Kickstarter up for this. And they've posted the stuff online, but as part of the Kickstarter, they're including, well, a custom personal mission for each class.
Oh.
That you can go on. And if you beat it, you get a special loot card explicit to that class.
Sure.
So it's kind of interesting.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. So I backed that. What you thinking, Chief?
What's this little symbol in the bottom right mean?
That means you have to add 2 negative 1 cards to your deck.
Okay.
To put that.
Because it's awkward armor, right? So.
Not that awkward. It's just like hide.
Heavy.
You sure you don't want that?
The invisibility cloak. That's funny.
It's kind of nice.
I mean, yeah, it would be kind of useful, but it's a spent item, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm gonna spend 20 and buy a shield.
Oh, that sounds good for you. Oh, and it's only a tap, as it were, or whatever. What do we call that in this game?
I don't even know.
Expend. I know you recovered them.
Yeah, via long rest.
Yeah, or even short rest, it looks like. Oh, no.
No, long rest only.
Long rest only. Okay. Oh, man. Refresh. Spend items.
That's it.
There we go. So it's rounded up, so if I hit level 3, I can carry 2 potions.
Mm-hmm.
That'll work. Yeah, Mr. Loot Ninja Mage over there that just kept grabbing all the gold.
Spend it. Can't take it with you.
You're sure? I will need
sort
the
of can.
Rules book. Or the map book. Oh, I forgot to grab that. Oh, it's right there. Convenient. Yay! Oh... By the what?
By the boots. The boots of striding look interesting. The piercing bow also looks interesting.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The piercing bow was kind of interesting.
During a ranged attack, ignore all shield values through the entire attack action.
Hmm.
I presume that can also apply to my magic attacks?
If they have range on them, yes.
And if they're attack.
Yes.
What else would they be if not attack?
I don't know.
Some spells don't say attack on it.
Yes.
Okay, well, I will check my spells and see what they actually say.
Cool. Gonna grab that?
Maybe. Gonna check my spells first.
Okay.
So we can talk about where we want to go while I'm checking.
Yeah, so the two locations are called...
Enoch Camp,
and yes, Crypt of the Dam.
Oh yeah, these all say attack on them.
Buy it. Are you not the shopkeeper or something?
Buy it. I'm getting cut back.
Oh, you do.
I get a cut. So the Boots of Striding here.
You wish.
During your movement, add +2 to move, and then you tap it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Under what circumstances do you recover?
Long rest.
Long rest. That might happen more often than I expected.
Well, we only usually do 1 or 2 long rests in a session.
Well, the good thing is it adds 2 to your movement.
And you can do that with the basic action on a card to get 4.
Or 6.
Oh, yeah.
I think I'll get this player. Piercing bow instead.
Okay, sounds good.
I'm so actually going to
subtract 30 gold.
Everyone's
buying.
Bye, bye, bye. Did you buy anything?
Yeah, bought the shield.
Oh, then I haven't. I'm the only one who didn't. Then again, I bought last time.
Oh, that's a loss, not a spend.
A loss?
Maybe yeah.
You consume it.
Oh. Yeah, that armor is tempting, but that 2 -1 cards, that's a real deterrent on that.
I'm going to get a Boots of Striding myself.
Yeah. Already. Sweet.
Well, the nice thing about the -1 cards is it makes the critical miss happen less often.
Yeah, it does.
Okay. So.
So we got to decide. City event, I'm down.
I'm down with the city event.
City event sounds good.
Let's
to me.
Let's do it.
Okay. New city event. Ah, the Sleeping Lion. Surely there is no better place to get a drink and relax after clearing out some dank dungeon. On this particular occasion, though, you are approached by a heavily scarred Inox. She sits at your table and pushes forward a piece of paper. An interesting party would like to hire you to steal a valuable figurine from the residents in the battlements. She says matter-of-factly, the details are on the paper. Meet me in the back alley in 2 days' time after the job is done. Option A, accept the mysterious job. You can handle anything. Option B, incredulously explain she must have the wrong people and you won't take the job.
So, if we're actually going Paragon...
Option B.
Yeah,
I'd go with Option B.
Want to steal shit.
Then you're in the wrong party, man.
Option B it is. You grab the Enox's arm as she is getting up to leave and push the paper back toward her. She looks incredibly angry as you explain that your group doesn't do this sort of thing. She wordlessly grabs the plans and storms out of the bar. No effect.
Okay.
If we had taken option A, we would have gotten 10 gold each.
Okay.
Mainly because you're in the party. If you weren't in the party, we would have lost 3 reputation each.
Oh, wow.
Or lost 3 reputation. What did, where does that even apply?
That would have dropped us down to -1, effectively. If we're still at no modification to the shop price, mm-hmm. but if we get one more reputation, we get a +1 to our shop price.
Oh!
Excuse me, a -1 to what
we get a discount.
Shop. Yeah.
Yeah, no, it did have a tier icon. I didn't that for you. I actually looked at the tier icon. Oh, we got our cards to choose from.
Yeah, I'm assuming we're going to do a scenario.
Yes.
Well,
so,
though technically, shouldn't we do the road event first?
Yeah, we're supposed
we
to do that first.
Which...
Well, I figured you get time to do it while he's reading, so.
Okay.
Not so much downtime.
So where are we going?
I'm with Peter.
I'm taking this one.
We'll go with number 3, since it's the next one in the...
Oh, just go in numerical order?
Yeah, until something else.
I'm fine with that. You fine with that, Nicole?
Yeah.
Okay. So we are going to... the Enoch encampment. Kind of appropriate after we just told an Enoch to fuck off.
So we said no, and now we're going to go murder her compatriarchs. Yeah, we're paragons of virtue, aren't we?
We don't know why we're going yet.
It's to murder a bunch of Enochs.
So we're going here for those watching
at
home.
Interesting assumption that you're making right there.
I'm probably right.
Yeah, you're probably right. Okay, let's fold that up and get that out of here. And I will pull our road event. You go ahead with the road event.
You are feeling a tad hungry as you walk down the road. You are considering stopping for a meal when you come across a thicket of bushes covered in green berries. The berries look delicious, but you hesitate. They could be poisonous. Option A, eat the berries. Option B, pass by the berries and just eat your normal rations.
I want some berries.
They could be positive berries.
That's what I'm thinking. I want some berries.
What kind of positive effects would we actually expect? Extra temporary hit points? Extra HP? Extra attack modifiers?
Some XP?
Maybe some bless cards into our decks?
You might get leveled?
Well, we can't level until we go back to the town anyways.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Netrian Odyssey, this is just inviting you to take damage.
Yeah. I'm going to say no. No berries.
Oh, no berries?
I want the berries.
What about you?
I'm going to say no.
Okay. Then no berries. Option B, pass by the berries and just eat your normal rations. Not wanting to regret making a stupid decision, you refrain from eating the berries and continue on down the road. No effect.
What would have happened otherwise?
Technically, we're not supposed to read it.
Oh, this is not a tear?
No.
Okay.
Put it on the bottom of the deck.
Yeah, as long as it's not a tear, then we don't read the other one. If it's a tear, then I read them. Okay. So, for our wonderful map today, you can pull these off.
That's an interesting assumption.
Wonderful,
he says.
One second. That'll go up there. These will be going off the sides. Oh, that is...
Doesn't matter which and what side they're facing.
What was that?
You just handed me 4 things.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They will go off the sides. I'm laying out this first.
Okay.
You're just a holder. You're a shelf. You've been reduced to an inanimate object. How's that make you feel?
Bad.
Inanimate object. You don't feel anything.
Exactly. Silly human.
Can you catch that off that?
You get to do things.
Okay, A side up. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, A is the last thing?
Yeah. So A side up, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4.
One is there?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the letter should be on the outer edge.
Oh.
Like this?
Yeah. Yep, just like that. And that'll apply on this side as well. Well, we don't have many places to start. Okay.
So this is also correct?
Yes, that is correct. Okay, so we need, what are they called? Totems. The 3 totems that I gave you, will go in these three spots. No, one right there. So we'll need to set those up. Then we have thorns, the three thorns. One right here. One right there. And one here, it looks like. Yes, right there. We need four doors, which I forgot to get out. Give me a second. Because, gee, they like to put doors on stuff. It's an amazing concept.
Well, that's really the only...
Closed doors. Can you put those over there on your side, Peter?
Mm-hmm.
That's really the only way that you can, whatchamacallit.
The only way you can get from one room to another?
No, preventing monsters from spawning.
Although they need to come out when the commotion starts.
Oh, there is a door on the backside.
Nope.
Couldn't picture it. Okay. There we go. Next up. Where are those? Okay. Snow crates and barrels. Ha ha, ha 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 ha.
Ha.
Ha. Oh. Who's our money person tonight?
Just throw them wherever there's one.
We don't put out any yet. Okay. So, we start out with... What are these things called? We need a shaman, who is an elite. We'll be here. It's all the way in the back there. And who wants to handle loading up some HP? I assume we're doing level 1 again.
Level 7.
Yes. Level 1 enemies?
Yes.
Okay, so elite shaman gets 9 hit points. Can probably mostly do ones on them. Yeah, we're going to be able to do only ones on all of them. Then he's got some archers. And the archers will have 6 hit points each.
Make it easier on yourself.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, there's a lot of guys in this room. Jesus Christ. Getting us off to a good start. So 6 on each of these. And we've got 6 of, what are they called? Enoch guards. And they have 8 hit points each. Be all of them.
Of 8 hit points?
Yep. Let's see. What the hell is he? Yeah, only one to start at least.
Bingo.
You just don't open the door, we'll be fine.
You say that now. Because nothing ever opens doors. We didn't learn that last time.
That's only a boss.
Fair. How do you know he's not a boss? Because I probably would have said boss.
Yes.
You don't bury the lead, usually.
You don't? Mm-mm. Okay, these will be for later, so we're fine for now. Figured while you guys were putting those on. Okay. So, we've got set of three guards. That'll be 1, 2, 3, and mirror on the other side. Yep. And then all the archers are back with the boss. Yep, and that's a mirror on the other side. So what do thorns even do?
Fuck if I know. Where does
they stab you?
Where do the archers go?
There and there, and same on the opposite side. Okay.
Have some fancy archers.
Pretty? Looking all pretty?
Never mind, I'll just send
it. Oh, neat. Yeah, oh, I saw it. We'll just shove this right here. This will work. And I'll need those tokens.
Put it up here if you need to.
Can they see it back there?
I have no idea.
Right here, you think? Yeah, that's good. Can you manage it?
Sure. Set. Your wife's right there to take her.
There you go.
She is the inanimate object of the night.
The inanimate object? Am I missing something?
Yes.
You are.
Do we want the hit point side or the art side to be facing the camera?
The hit point side. We're mostly helping people track them. And we'll be talking about the units well enough. We'll see how it goes. Then we have plot, it looks like.
Yes.
Okay. Introduction. First off, require... we could not have the merchant flee global achievement. So if the merchant had fled, we wouldn't have been able to do this. Goal. Kill a number of enemies equal to 5 times the number of characters.
20 enemies.
No problem.
Okay.
I'm guessing we're going to be opening up some fucking doors.
Yeah, look at that. We got half of them here already.
Yeah, we do. So, this merchant wants to make an example of some caravan raiders. Seems reasonable enough. For the right amount of money, almost anything can be made reasonable. You enter the Dagger Forest and begin to track down the encampment using Jaxera's crude map. It is well hidden, but following the signs outlined on the parchment, you find a dense cluster of huts in a small clearing of the forest. All that's left is to head in and make that requested example. Until door one is opened, one normal Enox guard spawns right in front of the door. At the end of every odd round, at the beginning of every round, because we're 4 players.
Okay.
So we'll have a guard spawn right here every round when we start.
That is a door.
No, this is door number one. That's tile one. It's, you know how they mark it on the map.
Okay.
So behind door number one, we have...
We don't know. Something probably important.
Well, the guard's coming out due to the commotion.
Okay.
We are murdering.
I know. I kind of caught on to that. I don't feel like the good guy anymore.
Yeah, pretty much. We are murdering them.
They're just sitting here minding their own business.
We thought we were taking
trying to make a living.
Silly us.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, it don't look like they're good at farming, so...
Are you supposed to use the sleeves for those? I mean, like...
We don't have to.
I know, but it...
still need for status effects, sir.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll make it a little...
Leads, disarms, stuns, all that stuff. We kind of need that.
And also, it just helps to
make it easier to see their stats so we don't get confused.
Okay, then we have to slide that all your way a bit. Quite a bit. Okay, let's stop
there. Is
that
good?
That may be good. Oh yeah, because we need to see the numbers on them. Okay. me 1 second. I need to find the good sleeves. There we go. So the guards we're going to have a shit ton of, so I'm putting him definitely in a 10 box. There we go. Archers. Next.
So you just put the shaman in the 10 box.
No, I put the guard in the 10 box. I just put the wrong deck in front of it.
Gotcha.
I'm doing great.
We're all doing great.
Yeah, it's been one of those weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now we have room to when we flip over the cards as well. Sweet.
Okay.
So I think we're pretty good. We could also try placing the tokens next to them. That maybe make it easier to see who's what. So why don't we try that first, and if it doesn't work out, then we'll start putting them on there.
Rico's not a fan of that idea.
Why not?
Figures are going to be moving around.
Oh, happy.
Things are going to be pushed about. Because they're going to move, we're going to be moving, and moving the tokens with them.
We might get lost.
Keep them on the board.
Okay. Okay, so...
Where's our possible starting location?
Oh, these five right up here.
So what happens if we happen to get here? Does it stop the guards from spawning?
There's rules about that. It spawns in the next open space, closest open space.
That sucks.
That was in the fact. Oh, and note, when I use like my shield thing, it only applies if you stay next to me. Also, shields are not negative one for all attacks when we use them. They're negative one for the next attack.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. It's unclear. Was that also the case for enemies? Do either of you remember from reading the fact? Okay.
I didn't actually read the fact, really.
Oh, you didn't?
I mean, I just read some of that.
Okay.
I didn't know there was going to be a test.
Okay, so now... Oh, I have to pick my thing. How about no? Wow. I got shitty ones. Okay.
So... What are the stats on these guys? What are they whacking for and moving and all that?
Okay, so the guards are 8 hit points, 2 move, 2 attack. We don't have any elites. We only have an elite shaman, was it?
Mm-hmm.
And no regular shamans yet. He is 9 with 2 movement, 3 attack, and 3 range. So he's technically an archer. Then we have the Enox archers are 6 hit points, 2 move, 2 attack, 3 range.
Wait, so are there any elites on the board?
Yes, just him.
Oh, that's what the yellow stands for.
Yeah.
The
yellow circle's on the bottom, correct?
Okay. So I assume people are planning to move?
Mm-hmm. Do the totems block line of sight for ranged attacks?
And are they optical?
Are what ops? Oh.
The totems. These?
I have no clue what the totems are for. I assume they're obstacles. Also... Thorns, they're kind of marked as though they're like traps.
That probably don't go away.
But it doesn't, it just says thorns times 3. There's no explicit details.
Thorns times 3 is the number of thorns you need.
Yeah, exactly. So we put down the 3, but they've got the red box here like they're like a trap. But I don't see any details on how those work, and there's nothing here.
They actually hurt us, or they slow us, or what?
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm wondering.
They're hazardous terrain. If a figure enters a hex with hazardous terrain via normal or forced movement, each hex will inflict half the damage of a trap rounded down. Flying and jump movements are unaffected by hazardous terrain. Unlike traps, hazardous terrain does not get removed after its effect is applied, but instead remains on the board indefinitely.
Oh, okay.
So half the damage of a trap rounded down is 1 damage. Oh, wait. Damage...
What's our trap damage for a
level? Oh, trap damage is just 3. Okay. So, yeah, one.
Oh, and of note, I have another healing spell. And it doesn't cost me to get rid of my card.
Nice.
Is this an open space, or is this also an obstacle?
That is just an open space. Yeah, that's just an open space.
Sorry, so do the totems block line of sight?
They do not appear to block line of sight, no. They just are an obstacle for movement. It appears.
So that means those archers are going to be pinging on us right at turn one?
They're surrounded with a green hex, so they would fit in with obstacles.
Yeah, do not hinder ranged attack.
Okay.
Well, that sucks.
Well, so, oh, yeah, that does kind of suck.
No cover for us.
It sounds like we're going to have, like, 11 attacks incoming on this round.
Yeah, pretty much.
It seems like it might be a good idea for us to blow some of our spendum cards right away to try and reduce the number of incoming attacks.
The idea is to actually get into one of these rooms.
Yeah.
That's actually a good idea.
Force them to come to us.
Yeah, that could be interesting.
The only thing is we got to actually open the damn door.
Yeah. And
kill the person in front of the door.
Yeah, that too. Hmm. Poison means they take extra damage when attacked, right?
Yes.
These guys are pretty low hit points.
8.
Fair.
I'd say 8. It's nothing to scoff at.
So do we want to shield up here where we are, or we probably need to move a little bit?
Let's figure out our strategy first. If our strategy is to move towards this room, we should probably be moving this turn and attacking the people between us and the door.
Yeah.
I concur.
That sounds good to me.
If we can knock out a person between us and the door early in the round.
And then open the door and possibly go in.
Open the door, maybe some of the people later in the round could go in.
Yeah. I'm going to use that.
Because hopefully we don't spawn more guys.
Yeah, that would be good.
So if we move to a door, which one do we want to move to? The warrior seems to be closer to that door, so that might be well suited for bashing our way through.
I can always move my character to another starting location also.
I think you're probably in a good spot. The only one I'm worried about is... that's you?
That's me.
Oh. Hard to say.
If we decide on that door, I could jump over to this side.
Which door do we want to go for?
Don't matter to me.
I say the far one, because the thorns are in a less...
Oh, yeah. Position. Yeah, that seems good.
Okay.
Oh, there's thorns on the other one.
Yeah, there's thorns right here.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
I'm down.
Okay, let's do this.
Okay.
Which one is the monster modifier deck?
Oh, actually, that would be this deck. I should move that into view. Actually, I can put that right here, it looks like. Yay! I'm changing out one of my cards, given... what we discussed. That may work. How do you open a door?
Walk on it.
Oh, you just walk onto it?
Okay. Or voluntarily.
Oh, voluntarily.
You cannot be forced to open a door by a push or pull or something like that.
I assume we can't force enemies to do that either.
Correct.
Okay. I am good. Oh, by the way, when you reveal cards, you're supposed to reveal all your cards. And they're that from that point on open to discussion, yada, yada, yada.
Yeah, I just do the one, so it's easier to see who goes first.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
I'm good.
Okay, shall we flip?
32.
20.
11.
34.
Okay,
and the bad guys.
Oh, sorry. I flipped these, right?
Yes.
55, 9,
ooh.
And 29.
Oh, damn.
And
the shaman goes first.
Do you have that bag of goodness over there, sir?
This one?
Yes.
Ah, he wants the Oreos. The mint Oreos. There we go. Okay, so the shaman's going first. Shaman has a move of 2. Range of 3. So can he get into range of us?
No way.
Okay, so he would take the best pass possible. 1, 2. And he's not in range. Woohoo! Oh, wait. Plus 1 movement. 3. He has an attack. He would curse and target 2. Good thing he didn't get in range of us. Do we have the curse cards available? We may end up needing those. Okay. Who's next after 9?
Me.
Sweet. Note that the guards will only be moving 1 space this turn.
So I move 2. Technically I heal 2, but that doesn't matter. And then I am going to use the Mind's Weakness, which is an augment on melee attack, add +2 attack, and then I attack 1. So technically attack 3 right now. And I'm attacking this guy, which is 5. And is going to be a +0, so I do 3. Do they have any shields? The guards?
Guards do not have shields.
Okay.
And retaliate on elites only.
Okay.
So how much wounds you got?
3.
Nice.
So that's 3 off, and I get an XP.
Yay! XP is always good.
I just need 1 more XP, and I will level.
I okay, think
when we get back to town, though.
Unless you get exhausted right now.
That would suck. Okay, who's after Nicole?
So I've got a 20. I think I'm next.
Yep.
All right, so I'll use the move 3 to move here.
Okay.
And you have attack of 2 at range 3. Let's see, any modifiers? Nope. So flip my deck. +1, so it becomes an attack of 3. They have no shield, so 1, 2, 3 tokens come off.
Yep.
Nice.
So he's got 2 hit points left.
Yay!
I believe it's actually the archer's next.
Yes.
29.
Yes, they're next. They have move 0, attack -1, but +1 range, and they will cause an immobilize. So they move 2.
Yeah.
So they move 2 and try to get into range of 4.
So that's these 4 guys in back?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
They can't get into range, thank God.
Yes.
Unless they want to shoot their own guys, which, you know, I mean, if that happened, I'm sure it would be, you know, terrible.
Well, can't you make that happen?
Hmm? Well, yes, but... yeah, but I can't get the immobilize effect, unfortunately.
True.
Okay, so I'm 34.
I am 32.
Go for it, Rico.
Alright, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the bottom part of this for a move 3. 1, 2, 3. The next step in that is a push 2. Target 1 adjacent enemy. 1, 2. So he takes 1 damage from the thorn.
Nice.
And then I will use the top one of this one, which is an attack 3, push 2 on this guy.
Nice.
So the attack is at a 2. So he takes 2. God, it's like all week.
Oh, playing defense grid.
And I will push him 2.
So he has to go the round that way.
1, 2.
Ah, nice.
And that is my actions.
Okay. Do we want that door open right now?
Did we just screw up and forget to spawn the guard?
Yes. Do we have a guard to spawn? No.
Okay, we didn't
screw up. Oh, wait. Let me see what the guard image is. We have all the guards out.
Oh,
so we
okay.
Nope. Is that a guard?
Nope.
Oh, those are all archers.
Those are shamans. Archers and shamans.
Yeah, all right, so we're good.
Yay! We didn't fuck up.
So now it is your turn.
Do we want to open that door? I can do it.
I would vote yes. That way we can see what the hell is about to hit us.
Okay, I can go for that.
That's the bad side, too.
Yeah.
We might get more stuff
hitting
us.
It's going to hit us.
Yeah.
Or it'll hit me. Being perfectly fair, can you move your cards off that in case...
You bet.
Yeah, thank you. Let's see.
50-50, man. Roll the die. See what happens.
I don't have a die. I'll just open the door. Okay, so I'm going to move up and do that first. Oh, I forgot to switch to mine. Okay, so I'm going to spend my move. So that'll go discard. Don't make that there anymore. And...
How far are you moving, sir?
All the way to the door. It's a move 4. So, and I open the door. Yay! What do we get? I need the barrel. It'll be by the open piece on the bottom.
So here?
Yep. I need 1 gold in the lower right corner.
Your right?
My right. Lower right. Oh, sorry.
This one?
Yeah. Looking from camera. Then we need a guard and a archer. No guards. So we only get the archer.
Yeah, we should. Probably gonna shoot you.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Actually,
at the
no,
end
he
of
won't.
Your turn,
his turn.
It's gonna shoot you.
Yeah.
At the end of my turn.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, so he gets 6 hit points and he goes right here.
Oh yeah, he's never gonna shoot the crap out of you.
I see how this goes. Okay, so I'm going to then play my reviving shock card. I get to attack 2 targets. I'm going to attack that almost dead guy. And
And
I'm going to attack the new guy. It's range 3, so I can reach both of them. Let's see how this goes.
So who are you targeting first?
I'll target the almost dead guy first.
Okay.
+0. He's dead. So now we've got a guard available.
Next. But he doesn't spawn immediately.
What? Oh, God, and then
I think that you may be giving Rico flashbacks.
Yeah. Oh God. Him and a friend played way too much of our board game balancing stuff this week. We'll be done next week. We'll be done with balance.
Does it hurt that bad?
Woo! 2x. Got a 2x damage.
Cool.
Okay.
So that means I do 4 damage to that fucker.
Oh, that sucks. If you want the gold, come with the
loot. Either that or use a loot, right?
Is this true? Oh, is he dead?
No.
Okay. He's got 2 left on him.
Okay. Oh, so I'll have to reshuffle my deck.
Yes.
Okay. So now the archer will go right away.
Yep.
-1 attack and immobilize.
I hope you like feathers, because you're going to be covered in them.
Now, we can move 3 when you're immobilized, right? We just get to end our turn on you?
Yeah, yes. Pretty much. So I'm probably going to get immobilized, unless this is a miss. +0. So, keep flipping him that way, so I will turn this around. He does 1 damage to me. Woohoo.
Slink.
And immobilizes me. Okay.
I hope you like holding the door.
Hodor?
Uh-huh.
Am I Hodor?
I think you don't want to be him, because we all know what happened to him.
They had him in the new HBO show intro. It was hilarious.
It'll probably be a flashback.
Yep.
Everybody else was doing the whole, and Hodor just pops up, Hodor. Okay, I think we're all done.
Guards.
Oh, the guard need to go. -1 movement. So, they move 1 with 2 attack. So, you're lower initiative, so you get hit.
What do you mean lower initiative?
I'm the only target.
Okay, fair. -1. So, no damage.
Got this.
Nice.
We'll take that. Okay, so now we need to shuffle the archer deck, I believe.
Yes.
Yes, and I need to shuffle mine. Anybody else?
Nope.
Negative.
Oh.
What's the natural range on the archers again?
Natural range is...
Four?
Three. They had a plus one. And I am immobilized. So I am definitely holding the door right now. Shit. So are we going to try to run into that room in general?
I'm planning to move early and to run into the room. And I've only got enough movement to get to one of these two spots.
Okay.
You think you'll be able to take care of the archer inside?
Seems likely, unless I roll bad.
Cool.
Although I can do something to improve my odds, which I probably will.
Oh man, he's falling shite.
The guy next to you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you planning to mostly stay there, or are you planning to go in the room?
Nah, I'm planning on staying outside, take the hits.
Okay.
Let you guys get situated. Hopefully I'll live long enough to actually come up and attack my...
If you can hold off your attack a little bit, I can help out. But dropping that decoy is kind of tempting.
So are we keeping track somewhere of how many we've downed?
Oh.
We have to kill 20, right? We've killed one now?
One.
Kill 20 and total enemies, yes.
All right, so should we have some way of some counters to keep track with?
Yes. Yep. Yes, we have that now. That would have sucked to be halfway through this. Ah, shit, how many?
I don't want to use these for counters.
Oh, wait. It's the start of a new round. Spawn the guard.
Yeah. Get to that one second. All right. You said you wanted me to hold up, right?
Just a little bit.
Hey, look, number five came back.
Number five is alive?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm good.
I'm good.
I'm good.
I am going at 18.
54.
8.
7.
And when I blow my stuff, you just have to come in and
We've got a guards going at 50. We've got the shaman going at 89.
Can't be good.
He's going to heal and bless himself. What does bless do again?
Put the bless card into his deck, I believe.
Great. Oh, he also, heals all adjacent allies.
Yeah, gain the bless attack modifier card.
And
so Bless would go into his deck, I believe.
Okay.
Yeah, though, he's only got...
And an archer. Archers get an extra move, but less attack.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, not going to complain about that.
I believe the 7 goes first.
Yes, or 8, is it?
7.
Oh, you've got a 7?
I've got a 7.
Oh, sweet. Go for it, Peter.
So I can spend my minor power potion to have a better chance of healing this guy in case I draw a neg 1. Do you think it's worth it?
It's hard to say.
How much HP is he on to?
He's got 2 HP, and I will do 2 damage, but if I draw a negative 1, I won't kill him.
I wouldn't be too worried about it.
Alright, I won't spend it now.
We might need it later.
There's my move 4. And my attack. Minus 2.
Oh, wouldn't have helped anyways.
Well, then I would have done 1 damage, now I do nothing.
Yes.
So you didn't waste it.
Yeah, I did not waste it. Ouch.
Alright. 0 is next.
Hi. Alright. Why am I having so much trouble with cards on this table?
It's because you shuffled it.
Yes. Okay, so I'm going to start with an attack 1, range 2, stun stuff. So, range 2 would be on him.
Nice.
It's an attack 1. This is not a melee attack, so I don't get the benefit of the mind's weakness. So it is a plus 1, so I deal 2 damage.
Nice.
And he's stunned, no?
And he's stunned.
Ah, screw you, number 4.
So yeah, that's number 4 gets a stun.
Guard?
Yep. Yes. I also increase the ice effect.
Oh, nice.
And gain an XP. What was that?
Winter is here.
It's not winter is coming, it's here.
Okay, so that's that. And then
can you tell we're excited about the upcoming Game of Thrones season?
Okay, and then I use the Gnawing Horde, so I summon a rat swarm. I need summons. Yes.
There you go.
Thank you. So that goes here, and then you can go there.
Oh! What? Yeah, it has to go there. Okay.
And then I gain 2 XP, putting me at 4. I don't really like these XP trackers.
No, I'm looking forward to the new spinners from the Kickstarter.
Yeah, so that's 4, and then, yeah.
Like, I knocked my HP token out.
Yeah. Okay, that's the end of my turn. That was, like, awesome.
So it looks like archers are next.
At 16, yep.
Yep, and they're move 3, range 3, attack 1. So I'm before you, so he'll attack me. He'll jump through. He'll also attack me. All right, no, he can reach Nicole.
But he goes to something shorter. Nicole's one further away.
Oh, yeah, that would have worked. Me? Not him. He's a shaman. Not in range.
4.
It's range 3.
Oh, it's on range 3 right now.
Yep.
They move.
3. So he'd stop one back, and he can't reach. Sweet.
So 1 and 2, looks like.
Both attack me.
Or attack me.
Okay. So, it's upside down. Okay, so number 1 attacks me.
Just can't win.
No, I can't. Number 1 attacks me with a plus 1, so I take 2 damage. And then what was the other number?
It's number
2. 2 attacks me. No damage. Hey, came out even on those draws. I can't complain. Okay. So now it's my turn.
There's another archer over here that's going to attack me, I think.
Oh, yeah. Good catch.
Didn't have to move.
No damage.
Nice.
Okay, so I get to... I'm buffing me and all adjacent allies get plus 1 attack. So if you are able to move next to me, you'll get it. Otherwise, your rat will get it.
Except my rat doesn't go this round and it dissipates.
Doesn't this stay out until I go again?
No, that's end of round, I think.
Yeah, is it the little...
If it's a circle, then I think it's
circle inside like a door.
Yeah.
It's only for the round.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It's not persistent.
Ah.
Alas.
So me, and if you manage to get next to me, we'll get it.
But I think you're melee, right?
Yes.
Well, he'd still be next to a guy at that point.
Oh, right. I see.
And then I'm going to do... Who do we want to poison?
If you can, the shaman.
I can't... He's all the way away. Can't reach 6. I can do within 3.
How many?
Just one. So somebody's at pretty close to full health?
They're almost all at full health.
Maybe this archer?
Yeah, maybe the front archer? Or would you rather me hit that guard next to you to help you kill him off?
He's stunned, so...
Oh, he is?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So he's not going to hit me this round.
This guard's another possibility?
Then I'll hit that guard.
Guard number 2.
Guard number 2? Okay. So, let's see if I get him. -1. Of course. I just can't win with these damn cards.
Nope. You didn't remove enough of those negative
ones. Oh, it's because the card is not even. Okay. Okay, so yeah, that's my only -1 left in my deck. That's it.
That means that next you'll draw a critical miss, so you can shuffle them back in?
Yep.
Yeah, pretty much.
Next one's going to be the null?
Yeah, or -2.
And then the null.
Yeah.
Got to maximize for the...
So he's still poisoned though, right?
I do 1 damage. And he's poisoned. Number 3, you said?
Number 2.
Guard or archer?
Guard.
Okay. And I pump earth. Yep. And that would be that. And I... Oh, wait. No, I deal 2 damage. Because I had the +1 buff up. I forgot about that.
this guy, right?
Yeah. Yep.
So he's got 4 hit points left?
Yep. Sweet. Okay, Rico, you're up.
Negative. It's the guards.
Oh, it's the guards first?
Yep.
Okay.
They're at 50. I'm at 54.
Ah. Okay, so they are regular move and attack. So 2 move, 2 attack.
All right, so he is stunned, so his stun now will
goes
be
away.
Gone. One. Two.
Yep.
Two.
Yep.
One, two. One, two.
Wow.
And looks like number 2 and number 6 will be whacking at me.
Okay, so number 2 for 3 damage.
Okay.
One, two,
three.
Number 6 for 2 damage. Didn't want more damage?
No.
No. Shoot. More damage is good, man. Let's just, you know, eat it all.
I forgot I had the shield.
You could have used it.
Nah, I have to decide before the modifiers come up.
Oh, you do? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. So that's something to be aware of.
Yeah, if
you
got
don't want to
armor.
Pull too fast.
Yeah, if you got armor, you want to, you have to declare using it.
Okay.
That way, if a negative comes up, you're like, oh, no, I didn't use it.
Yeah.
You still used it.
That makes sense.
There's no retroactivating some junk here. All right. So, for my first one, I am going to use the top one of this to attack 2 adjacent, which will be these 2 guys.
Okay.
For an attack of 3, I'll do number 4 first for an attack of 2.
Okay, that would be him.
Yep. And then number 2 is a plus 0, but since he is poisoned, I'd be 4 damage to number 2.
And he's dead.
Let's mark off another dead guy.
And we need 8 hit points on this guy?
Yes. I do get an XP for that.
Oh.
And for my second one, I will... It says move 3.
You have to end your turn. Okay.
And then push 1, target all adjacent enemies.
Next to me will work.
Get out of here.
And that's it.
And
okay.
That means you get the loot.
Which is the biggie.
Priorities.
Hey, he watched the Loot Ninja Mage last game.
Mm-hmm.
Taking all the goddamn cash.
So, now the Shaman?
At 89, yes.
He has a move of 1. And he will have a range of... doesn't matter. He heals him and the guy next to him, him and the guy next to him 1. Doesn't matter. And bless.
Did we figure out that bless jump? Yep.
Yeah, it looks like it... I mean, what it looks like is it's just shuffled into the monster.
Do we have a bless card?
Oh, the monster deck.
Because that's where
that's where the monsters are. Yeah.
Oh!
Yeah.
I mean, that's the only guess that I have, because otherwise it doesn't seem to make much sense.
He's making all the monsters better.
Is this the bless? Or...
the white, yeah.
Yeah.
That's a bless. Times 2.
But it does go away once it pops.
Yeah.
So it just shuffles in.
That's as far as I can tell, yeah. It doesn't reshuffle those cards, though.
Okay.
So likelihood of them drawing it goes up.
Yes.
Score.
Especially with how I shuffle. Hey, for fuck's sake, I have 1 negative 1 in that.
And that would be it, correct?
I believe so, yes. Which means everything is now... yeah, are all these facing the right way now? Yes. Okay. So, how bad's your health?
I'm currently 5 out of 10.
So you could use some healing.
Yes.
So I have a heal 3 that I can use if you can get within range 3 of me. Assuming that you can't heal.
I'm planning to heal him a lot.
Okay, I won't worry about it then.
And, oh, in usual, when we're talking, don't talk like you're not supposed to say actual numbers on any cards when you're mm-hmm. planning.
Okay, I thought you just weren't supposed to say the initiative number.
Initiative, range, damage numbers,
yeah.
Stuff like that.
I'm gonna attack the guy for
it. Like, you could have said, if you can get a little closer to me, I could heal you. That you could say something like that.
Or you could just, you know, show me your card.
You're under the table.
Oh, right. I'm no longer immobilized.
Yes. Trade cards.
Actually, there's a card in the Tinkerer's deck that lets you do that.
That could be interesting.
Yes, I can cause people to trade cards.
They stay traded or they go back at the end? Well, we can handle that later.
It's not. It's a level 9 card, so I doubt I'll ever see it.
Oh, that's very, whatchamacallit. What's the name of that thing? It's not pessimistic. It's that thing where you, like, damn it. It's not pessimistic, but it's close.
Optimistic.
No, not
realistic. Realistic, I like
fatalistic.
That's a good one, too.
Fatalistic, that's what I was looking for.
Well, we've been that way all along with Tony's drop pile.
Yeah.
You're probably going to get the shit kicked out of you this round, aren't you?
Yeah. Maybe so.
Wait, so do we still have ice?
Yes.
Okay.
Since I have a low deck size, I will probably be doing a long rest next round.
You still have 4 cards, it looks like.
Yeah, don't I have to use one for the long rest?
No.
No, not on your card.
You lose one out of your discard.
2 rounds, and then I'll do a long rest.
Okay.
And the poison goes away off the guard number 2.
Oh, right.
Wait, no, it doesn't.
Because he died.
Oh, he died. Okay.
<came back. laughs>
Okay. Okay.
All right.
Sorry.
Well, in that case,
that kind of sucked. Permanent debuff on that number.
Uh huh.
Okay.
I'm good.
Try not to get any farther away from me if you can.
So, do barrels here like get investigated by moving on top of them, or
no,
do they just
obstacles.
Sit there?
They're just sitting. They're just obstacles. You've got that card, Peter, that lets you get back all your lost cards, right?
Yes.
And that becomes lost in place, correct?
Right, and that becomes lost afterwards.
Just a note, I can get that back for you now. So, if you
that
want...
That could end up very handy.
So, if you want to play more the style of burn through stuff quick to do some really awesome stuff, take your own stuff back, and then I give you back that card to get it all back again later, we can do that setup.
Okay, that sounds cool. Right now I am not well positioned to do it because I need lots of enemies around me to do that.
It looks like we're all
but
good.
Just something to keep in mind.
Yeah, I think we're all good.
27.
20. I am 48.
36.
And then them?
Oh, right. 35?
Yeah, they do get to go.
74. Okay, I was worried with that shaman, that first card we drew, he's going to be a fast fucker. And 29 on the archers.
Okay.
And that's a reshuffle for them.
So 20 is the lowest, I think?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, wow.
So my,
Your rat.
My rat goes first.
Yep.
So he chews on the guy.
Number four.
With a +2, so he freaking one-shots the bastard.
Wait, he got a +2?
Yeah.
Well, it's not one-shot, since he was wounded.
Yeah, but, like, it was a little bit surprising. So, yeah.
We're up to 3.
Nine.
So, go rat.
Swarm.
Uh-huh.
He's got a brother. Let's not forget about his brother.
Okay, so then ice. Yeah, then it's my turn. So, I am going to... Is there anybody in particular we really want dead?
The shaman.
Mm-hmm.
The shaman?
Yeah. He has a lot of way.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So
six.
That's No, that doesn't matter. Stop. Force one enemy within range 5 to perform attack 2, range plus 0, targeting another enemy with you controlling the action. So, And shoots the shaman.
When you do that, you draw from this deck.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And it would be at disadvantage.
Oh, is that disadvantage?
It's a ranged attack next to a person.
Okay.
Okay.
So zero. Plus zero. So it's 2 damage to the shaman. Does he have any shield?
Nope. Nice.
Is he doing anything?
Who? Mm-hmm.
What?
So do we just do a basic attack, or are the archers going off of their stuff?
It's attack 2, so it doesn't include any of that.
Yeah.
It's straight up that.
Gotcha.
Now, it does take their range into account, but... So then I move over here.
And stab fool.
And stab somebody.
Woohoo!
So I stab the guy with an attack plus 3 because of the mind's weakness. It's only an attack 2.
Is it plus... Wait, so you said attack plus 3, and it's a base attack 1.
Yeah.
So it should be attack 3 after the negative 1.
Huh? 1, 2, 3.
Oh, you said plus 3.
Sorry,
I thought it was plus 3 off the card. I misheard you.
No, my bad.
Okay. That it?
Yep.
Who's up next? We got 29 for the enemy.
27 for me, 36
for me.
You're up, Rico.
Alright, how much is left on number 6 over yonder?
This guy here has 6 hit points.
Yep. And then the other two each have 8.
Damn. Just out of range.
Just out of range?
Yep.
Shit.
And I need to stay that far from you, right?
Yeah. That'd be good.
Instead.
Well, you can see my card now, so I have a range 3 on a heal.
I'm going to move 4, but only move 1. 1, 2, 3. I got an attack of 3, range of 3, and 1 XP. So it will be an attack of 2 on the shaman.
Down to 5.
And I get 1 XP.
Nice. How's your draw deck doing?
Pretty good. 2 more rounds.
Okay. Okay.
Next up?
I think it's Archers.
Archers,
yep.
I think.
29, right?
Yep. So they're move 0, so they have a move of 2, range of 4, and attack of 1.
So they don't have to move at all.
And it looks like they're all on you?
Yes, sir.
Actually... Wouldn't they go after my... Oh, wait, no, closest, isn't it?
It would be me.
Okay. Yeah.
And so, they're all in range.
Yeah, all 4 of them. Well, first let's do Peter.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay. So Peter's up first. And he's a negative 1, so no damage.
Phew.
Then we have...
let's do whatever this one is. Yeah, number 2, shoot me in the face.
Number 2. For 1. And you are officially immobilized.
Do you want to, like, use your shield or anything?
Not quite yet.
Okay.
And we'll go with number 1. Shoot me in the face.
2 damage.
Oh, shit. I should have used the shield. Alright, now I'm using my shield.
Was it supposed to, would it have been for all attacks?
Nope.
Okay.
1 attack only.
And good call!
Oh, that's still gonna do me in, though.
How
Wait,
bad?
You use the shield, though, right?
Yep.
How much does it?
Shield
oh, it only
1.
Gives you 1 shield.
Yeah.
It's only 2 damage. Wait, you only have 2 hit points?
Yes.
Oh, fuck.
Wait, you said it's 2 damage, but, like, that does a shield of 1, right? So then it's 1 damage?
Yeah, this is true.
You'll be down to 1 hit point.
Yeah. And I'm going to heal you up.
Hopefully I won't have to throw another card because I got 1 more archer shooting me.
No, we did all 3.
Are you moving before the guards, though?
There's...
We've got number 3 right here.
Oh, I missed him. So you're down to 1 hit point?
Yep.
Times 2.
There goes a card.
Yep. That was probably the better one to throw it on. At least you didn't lose 2 cards.
So we reshuffle monster deck at the end of the turn, right? Why don't we turn that sideways so that we remember to reshuffle?
Ah, good call. Thank you.
Unless I can just turn the times 2 sideways, so it'll look out of place.
Yeah.
Okay. Now you're all good? Mm-hmm. Okay, so now it's... Who's after that? I've got 48. Oh, 35.
35 on the guards and then me at 36.
Oh, shit.
Well, the guards are... Some of the guards are going to come after me.
This is true.
Yes. Okay, so guards next. Negative one movement, but they have range.
What?
Yeah, they have range two, negative one movement.
Okay. One standing next to me, one... Well, what's the numbers?
What's their move?
Their move will be one.
So he will be at disadvantage.
So he shoots at you at disadvantage.
Okay.
Plus two, or plus one?
Plus one it is.
Yeah, so you take three damage.
Ow, mother.
That's a lot for you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Next one, he can just shoot you from there.
Mm-hmm.
Null.
Okay. All
right.
Next one will move his one, and he's in range of both of you. Who's higher initiative?
Her.
Okay.
I'm lower initiative, which is the important thing.
Negative one. So he is just one damage.
Okay. I'm fine. I'm fine.
And move those other two guards one.
Braves are running, running away.
Bravely.
Okay, so now I'm 48 and you're 36. You're up.
Okay, let's see if I can put this archer out of my misery. So I'm going to use the bottom, which is attack 2, range 2, but that means get 1 XP, right?
Yep.
So let's try that. Neg 1.
Slowly chipping away at him.
Chink, chink, chink.
Getting rid of all those negatives now.
Now this I can use either as a move or an attack.
Over on the other side, what'd you do?
On this side I did the bottom, so I have to use the top here.
Correct.
So I can do an attack of 2, or I can blow the card and do lots of damage. I think I will just do an attack of 2 to the space right in front of me, since I
do have enough range. How much range?
Well, this default attack is only a melee attack right
that
in front
is
of me.
That's correct.
So I don't have enough range.
No, but if you blow the card, how much range?
Well, if I blow the card, I can attack all the enemies on the path to the target with a range of 4. So it seems worth saving for another occasion.
Yeah. Though, you will get your cards back later, so you could hit only one guy. Yeah.
Yep.
One guy for a lost card. Mm-hmm.
And that's my turn.
Okay. It's not my turn?
Yep.
Okay, healing you for 4. I think I'm going to be healing you again, aren't I?
I think so.
And I'm giving you, I'm spending ice and letting you take 2 of your discards back. Your choice. That's my turn.
Shaman is now...
What the hell is that? I didn't notice that symbol before.
That kind of...
Move is negative one.
I don't know.
Yeah, that's a different symbol.
Cannot recover.
Oh, so it's lost and can never recover.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think so.
That makes sense.
Yeah, it's kind of a powerful card.
Yeah, it is.
So, Shaman.
Okay, Shaman is move of 2, range of 5.
All right, so he does.
Oh, wait, no, sorry. Move of 2, range of 4.
So he doesn't have to move.
Okay, negative 1 attack. Or wait, sorry. Oh, I'm looking at the wrong guy. Okay, shoot. Shaman, move of 1 and range of 3.
So he doesn't have to move.
Okay, so still the same. Plus 1 attack, so 4 damage.
Holy shit. There's another card.
Flat 4. I healed you 4. You should be able to take that.
Oh, yeah.
Well, unless it's 4 damage, you might just want to...
Yeah, you know what? It's 4 damage, and I'll just lose a card. Which ain't going to help me in the long run.
Ooh. This is rough.
I don't want to lose these cards. 4 damage it is. I'll be running into the room next. And I'm going to be hiding.
Okay. And I think that's it. So, our turn. Mm-hmm. Or no, we have to pick new cards. Oh, and shuffle this.
Now, is anyone going to be doing a short rest?
We need to...
Nope.
We're going to... We need to
shuffle. I will be doing a long rest next turn.
We need to shuffle our turn. So you are going to need to do a rest. You're saying next turn?
So this turn I'm fine. Next turn I will have to do a long rest.
Oh, shoot, I missed a couple.
Well, I'll have to do a rest. I would like to do a long rest.
Okay. I may be able to prevent you from having to do that.
Well, if you give me back two or three of these cards,
I can give the whole thing.
Oh. That might work.
Yes. But I think you have to be right next to me.
I am right now.
Yeah. So I'll have to see.
I think I'm going to be moving pretty light, if that makes a difference.
I think I need to heal Rico again.
That should probably be your top priority.
I'm going to be running away.
Are you going to be running fast?
I'll be running fast, just not far.
Okay. Will you be making it into the room?
Yes.
Okay. That's the important thing.
So I'm running late, but if you are near me, then I might be able to heal you instead of attacking if we need it.
Okay.
Fuck you guys, I'm stabbing things.
Thank you.
That's good.
That's very good. We need that.
Alright,
I'm good.
Okay. I'm going at 37.
I am 14.
15.
The guards are just standing there. Don't attack a guard right next to them. You can attack range.
Until after that goes off, though, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So you can attack them before that goes off. Good point. But they're going at 15, so pretty quick. The shaman is just doing regular move attack late. And the archers are... extra move, lower attack.
But Jesus, 16.
Oh, yep. Shit.
And I'll be going very late.
Okay, so I'm first.
What are you, Rico?
15.
Oh, good, you beat the archers.
So, I go first. I am going to be invisible.
That seems good. I like that.
Yeah, please do not shoot.
Oh, sorry about the earthquake, people.
Where's the invisible token?
Oh.
So that's that. And then I am going to replace the mind's weakness with parasitic influence, which gives me a heal on my melee attacks.
Oh, nice.
And then I'm going to stab the guard right next to me. Oh, wait, I forgot. I shouldn't be doing this yet, technically speaking.
Why?
Your rat first.
Because my rat needs to go first.
Oh.
Two.
He can go either way. I'd send him at the archers.
Yeah, though he's going to get shot to shit.
Yeah.
Massive.
Oh, you can only move one?
Oh, yeah.
I can't move. I'm immobilized.
Oh, shit.
Oh, fuck.
That's a bad day. Okay, so with the parasitic influence, I am going to stab the guard that's next to me. He does not retaliate yet. My attack is just one, which kind of sucks, but one. So, one damage off that guard. I gain 2 hit points back because of the parasitic influence, and I gain a experience. Putting me to 5.
Sweet.
This is not good for Rico.
No. No, it's not.
Well, shit.
Oh, alright, so looks like me and the guards are going.
Yep, so you go first.
I'm just going to swing at the darkness. And I'm going to use the bottom part to activate my shield self +1 for the whole round.
Oh, nice. I may save your ass with that -1 on the archers.
I'm hoping.
How many hit points you have?
One.
I am completely changing up what I was doing with these two cards.
I can technically take three hits.
So, okay, so the guards...
now activate their shields and their retaliate feature.
Yep.
Followed up by the...
archers.
Four archers that are on the board.
That are all plunking at... Oh, whoa.
Nope, five archers on the board, my fault.
Who went first, you or Rico?
Me, but I'm invisible.
No, that's important because...
Oh, the rats.
The rats are going to take the shots first.
All right, so let's start with number five on Peter.
Oh, yeah.
As per usual... SOP.
Plus one, so you're getting hit for two.
Tink, tink.
You just can't down that guy, can you?
Okay, let's start with...
we're sitting here mano-a-mano, and
yeah,
neither
that's
one of us is doing
one.
Much.
So him. For one. To the rat.
Okay, so...
Oh, you need tokens.
Rat has hit points.
How many hit points?
Six.
Oh, good. Next, we'll do this guy on the rat. -2. No damage. Last guy on the rat. Null.
Damn it. Why?
What a tough rat.
Ah, thank you. And one damage.
Takes up by the shield.
Nice. Okay. I'm at 37.
That would be you.
Yep. I'm not till 69.
Oh, you're not till 69? Oh, the fridge open. Somebody left the fridge open.
Oh, sorry, that was me.
Okay. So. Shit. I think I'm going to stick with my original plan suddenly. Since, Rico is... You're planning to run next round. Okay.
But we do have the Shaman left.
Oh, shit. And he's going to move two and attack. So he can't reach. Oh,
yes,
wait.
Yes, he can.
Shit.
He'll walk right through that archer, no problem.
Okay, changing up my plan. You are healing by five using both my cards. That's not what I originally planned to do, but it seems the appropriate logic right now. Now Shaman goes before Peter.
Yep, Shaman's next on me.
So he's attack three, face.
Doesn't he have range?
Oh yeah, he's range three. So he didn't even need to move. Good catch. Two damage.
So one damage.
Yeah, this was a good turn to activate that shield.
Yeah.
Or that shield, I guess.
Yeah. And the round is over.
I do believe so.
I would like to move first.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, and I forgot to change up stuff. Sorry about that.
I have to have some words with this archer here.
What? Another -2? -1?
So, see, I can blow a powerful card or I can just walk up next to him. I think I will just walk up next to him, so using this 2 and this 2. A whack! Survey says. I got him.
Finally! Bastard. Yay! Then you turn around. Okay.
Do we remember where we killed another guy?
Somebody grabbed some loot.
Oh, I grabbed the loot, so that's why there's only three on the board.
Oh, yeah. Wait, so that was another guy, right?
Yeah, that's 4-4. That's why I was...
Oh, wait. Oh, we already got it. Okay.
Yeah, that's why I was counting coins. And I was like,
we've killed a whole four.
Four guys. Yep.
Yeah.
That's it.
We need 16 more.
16 to go. No problem, man. It's an XP farm.
See, that only works if we knock out everything else.
Yeah, it's fine. We got this.
Okay.
Do those guys ever run out?
What? There's 6 total tokens. They don't run out otherwise.
We can't have more than 6 on the board,
so
but that's the only
one. So, we kind of want to, technically speaking, prioritize the archers if we could.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm planning to hit them really hard.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's your ship. That's
I'm good.
I'm good.
I'm on resting.
Sorry, I was planning to give you your cards back if you need a healing.
No problem.
The bad guys need to shuffle.
Yeah. The guards and the other deck.
I'm good. So remember that you heal too as part of your long rest when it happens.
Oh, I had totally forgotten, but yeah, don't get until the end.
Yeah.
Okay.
32.
Oh, are you good, Peter?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you're long resting.
99.
I'm 19.
27.
Okay. 55 on the guards. 23 on the shaman. He's just healing.
43.
Yep, and the archers are 14, and they create the 3 damage trap adjacent to them.
Ouch.
And they're -1 move, -1 attack.
Buggers.
Yeah, kind of annoying.
That's going to be a lot of traps.
Yeah, it is.
I only had somebody could push.
So is there anybody faster than 14?
Nope.
Nope.
Well, shit.
So we're down to 4 archers.
And they just created 4 traps. And
they do an attack, though.
Oh, move, attack, and then create the traps. Okay. Order of operations, sometimes important.
So let's start with 3.
Technically speaking, it should be in number order, by the way.
Oh, so let's start with number 1. What's their range?
Their range is 3.
Alright.
Looks like they're... Who's lower initiative? You or Nicole?
What's yours?
Minus 32.
Okay, then I am lower initiative.
So the rats get hit.
The rats get hit.
So number 1 is shooting at the rat swarm.
For no damage.
Okay.
Number 2 is same thing. Will be the rat swarm.
2 damage.
But we need to throw down traps. Because for number 1...
Put that wherever you need it.
It's so what's the rule on where the trap
closest
is?
Closest to enemy. An empty adjacent hex.
Okay. Well.
Cheater.
No, that's the only
spot. Yep.
Oh, it's him. Oh, I thought it was
number
him.
Number 1.
Oh,
it has
okay.
to be empty and adjacent.
And now who's next?
Would be number 4. What's their current range?
3. Yeah, 3.
1, 2, 3. Once again, the rat swarm.
2 damage.
And I need another trap.
You've got him by you.
How much damage does the rat swarm take?
It will. The next one will kill it.
And number 3 is shooting at me.
Oh. That would be 3 damage. God damn, you've been getting the shit kicked out of you this game. Okay. Who's up next? 23 on the shaman.
Shaman it is.
I'm 19.
I'll advantage you.
Okay. I'm going to use my net shooter, and I'm going to hit the 3 archers right there. So I'm hitting these 3.
Okay.
And I'm using my eagle eye goggles for advantage on the attack. Let's hope this goes well. It's either a +0 or a +0. Son of a bitch. I was hoping to get like at least like a +1, maybe the 2x.
So which one were you shooting first?
Doesn't matter.
So +0 on number 1.
Oh, +0 on number 1. Oh, so we'll go in numerical order.
Sure. So that's 3 damage, right? Because it's an
attack.
Yeah,
3 damage to him. Oh, and then I have to do advantage for all of them. I forgot it's different for each guy. So whatever number's next.
How many you said these 3, right?
Yeah.
So number 2.
+1.
+1.
So 4 damage.
Number four.
Times two. Six damage.
Bam.
Take them off.
So which ones are left? One and two?
One, two, and three.
And drop the loot here?
The ones I hit.
Oh, one and two.
They are both immobilized.
Okay.
And so, I gain 3 XP.
And we are now done with 5 of these guys.
Woohoo!
Is that a loss?
Huh?
You used the top portion of it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Yeah, that's a loss. Okay, and now shield me. Me and anyone next to me. So I didn't want to shield. That's right.
You wanted to move?
I wanted to move. Trying to get out here and hopefully take hits for him.
Okay.
27, 23 for the shaman.
He just heals 3. He would move into range if it was available.
Is that 3 to adjacent?
No, just him.
Just him.
Shit. So he's 1 off of 4.
Though that doesn't say self.
You can always heal self, though.
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying, like, it. Technically, he could have healed the guy who was next to him if they had any hit points down, which he
doesn't. Yeah. Yeah, he doesn't.
Yeah. He wouldn't move through the trap, probably, to get to the guy that needs healing. He'd just heal himself, so that makes sense.
Next up is... I can't... Archer's going to guard you.
Okay.
Stab a fool. Repeatedly.
Hopefully kill. I like killing. Killing's good for us.
Oh, wait. What am I doing? The rats go first.
Yeah.
They're dumb. So...
Hey, you got rid of a trap.
I'll get rid of the trap with them.
Okay.
Because, I mean, that kills them.
That kills them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Poor Rick.
Yeah.
You're setting your own brethren to die.
They're not my brethren. They're not humans.
You're a rat, aren't you?
Yeah, but...
Wait, you are?
You're escaping.
Oh, yeah, you
basically,
are.
Yeah. I am going to use my poison dagger to, during your melee attack, add poison to a single attack.
Nice.
I'm going to use feedback loop, so on attacks, I gain shield 1. And then I stab the guy who's next to me.
It'll be number 6.
So it is going to be plus 0, so I deal 1 damage to him. And I get 1 of my shields.
Nice.
And I also gain an experience for using the augment. And then I am also going to use my Boots of Striding. And this is a normal move.
Gonna leave me out here.
Because I'm not invisible anymore. So yeah, that would be the end of my turn. Actually, I will also use my minor stamina potion to recover 2 cards, and I'll figure out which ones I want right now. Well.
So 32. Yep, I go before the guards. I will also use my pot.
Oh, to recover 2 cards?
From my discard pile.
Ah, nice.
I'll figure which 2 out. Then I will swing at the air. I'll activate my boots. Go a total of 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, that guy, whoever I attacked, is poisoned, by the way.
Yeah, I marked him.
Okay, good.
And that is the end of my turn. It is the guards at 55.
Okay. -1 movement. So you only move 1. So up. Where are the other guards? That's it? Okay. One is going to attack me. Oh, and what are all the guards? Well, we have all the guards out, aren't they?
Yes.
Okay. They all gain strength for next attack, which means they... Is that advantage? Advantage on their next attack. Okay. And then the one attacks me for 1 point of damage. Yay.
And you are going at 99, sir.
Alright, so recover 2 hit points, lose this card, get these cards back. That's all I can do.
Anyone taking a short rest?
I'm wondering if I should.
I'm not.
So that is my entire turn, right?
No. A short rest is you would lose a random card from the discard pile, and you don't get the healing, and you don't recover your Evil Eye Goggles.
I get cards back.
Yes.
You'll get cards back, correct.
I think I'm fine.
Alright, so the shaman needs shuffling.
Yep. No, there's nothing there.
So strategy-wise, are we finally going with our original plan of sticking in this room and waiting for them to come get us?
The archers can usually stay a good amount of ways, because that doorway really don't do much for us. All that's going to do right now is force the guards to come at us.
Yeah.
Which may or may not be a bad thing.
Well, they have to go from any part of the hex to any part of your hex. So...
they can also reposition too.
The archers will reposition and be able to shoot in.
Mainly it's trying to draw the guards in further, but I think we just use this room as a long rest room.
Yeah.
If possible.
Which I think we're all looking at right now. And then we have to hop out and start attacking.
Yeah, because after this round I will be doing a long rest.
I'm trying to figure out if I should hop out and start attacking right now.
Go big!
If you have a big attack, it might be worth trying to kill those two archers.
So I have a big attack, and I also have a cloak of invisibility. So
that would
work. I'll out and put that cloak on, but I might be unprotected at the start of next turn. Does this last until my next turn?
Yes.
Okay, so yeah, in that case, I should stay protected.
Okay.
So I'm going to plan to hop out, waste a really big attack.
And then you can actually pop invisible.
And then pop invisible.
I'm planning more or less to hit and run, because I'm going to need a long rest next turn. I'm good.
Oh, wait. Are we choosing our thing?
Our two cards, yes. Yeah.
Okay, I'm set.
Okay, I'm going out of 16.
And it doesn't really matter for
18.
Me. 14.
7.
35 on the guards. 23 on the shaman.
Again.
He's healing.
Healing again.
Well, he'll be full. And archer's at 31.
Okay, so 14,
Seven.
I think. Okay.
So you're going first, Peter.
So I'm going to hop out here.
Oh, try to be careful bouncing the chair. That's what's causing the earthquake.
I'm going to pop my cloak of invisibility, so I will be invisible until my next turn.
Yeah, and that's technically lost, I think.
Okay.
So it's not tapped, it goes into
this
your
is an attack path. 3, range 3, target 3.
Your cloak is lost, I think.
Yes, it goes into your lost.
Okay.
Yeah.
So attack 3, range 3, target 3, so I can get 1, 2, and then one of these guys. 3, I guess. And I'm going to quaff my minor power potion to give me a plus 1 on all 3 of those attacks.
Ooh.
See, none of them have
attack
shields,
4,
right?
Attack 4, range 3. Nope, none of them
have
shields.
Nobody has shields in this game, do they?
Nope.
So I might as well spend this, too.
Is that a discard as well?
Yes, they're all 3 discards.
And what does that do?
Absolutely nothing.
No, the bow.
Absolutely nothing. So the question is, why am I spending it when it's doing absolutely nothing? And there's maybe some reason.
Oh, okay.
During your attack, ignore all shield values for the entire attack action.
Oh.
So if they never have shields,
yeah.
I might as well just spend it.
Yeah.
Okay, so now attack 3, range 3, target 3,
attack 4.
Plus 1, so it's attack 4. And I don't have disadvantage, so let's do this guy first.
Okay.
So that guy has poison, I believe?
He is poisoned.
So it's minus 1, so I only do 4 points.
Yep, with the poison you do 4
minus
points.
Minus 1, plus 1, so he's dead.
Dead.
Woot.
So another to the dead pile.
How many are we up to?
Send him over here. I'll fill him.
And we need a gold.
And now this archer.
Which one?
This archer here.
Okay.
Attack 4. Plus 1. Dead. 5 points. And now this archer here. Attack 4. Minus 1. 3 points.
Still
also
dead. Hey! That was useful.
And this card is lost. At least for now.
So how many now do we have dead? Should be 8, I believe.
That is currently 7.
Yeah, yeah, I don't think you put 1 for the last one. Okay, so that increased our count. Also increased my survivability a bit.
We need 12.
Okay, I'm at 16.
I'm at 14.
And Rico?
18.
Okay.
So I am going to go invisible again.
You got your token? Yep.
And then I am going to go running out into the middle of the field. Or maybe not. Oh yeah, there I can. 1, 2, 3. And I guess I'll stab this guy, maybe? So that's attack of 1, minus 1, I do 0. But I do gain a shield, as if that's going to do anything with my thing. Okay.
Okay. And now me?
Yep.
How's your hit points? Oh.
2.
You are healed 5. Oh, wait, shit. You're not within 2 of me, are you?
Negative.
Okay, you are not healed 5.
Well, you could move and heal, but yeah.
Yeah.
But I understand you may not want to do that.
No. Wonder if I want to be a greedy son of a bitch.
Ouch. I can throw you under the bus, man.
Yeah, that's his choice.
I'm going to probably get beat on a little bit, aren't I?
Probably.
Okay. I'm going to heal myself all the way up and get 2 XP.
That's a lost.
Oh, right. Thank you. Haven't used many of those, but need to pay attention. And then I'm going to loot 2.
Shit.
Nice collection you got there.
Yeah, I just noticed that and I was like...
Did you gain the XP from that?
Oh, no, I did not. Thank you. Puts me at 6. Okay. Oh, and I wasn't even showing myself.
Alright, 18. So yeah, I'm going to heal myself for 2. And then do no attack. That's it.
Okay, so now it's all of them, I believe. Yep, he heals up to full. Then we move on to the archers. Move 2, attack 2, range 3. So there's no archers, is there?
Number 1.
Oh. Is this guy an archer?
No.
No.
Okay, so he can only see... or I'm his target.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Neg 2, no damage. Next we have the... Oh wait, the guards. Negative 1 movement, so they only have 1 move, but they have 2 range. And 2 attack.
Oh, they have range?
And they have advantage.
Ooh.
But they have disadvantage.
Why?
For number 2 and 3, or 1 and
well,
3.
Well,
no, they can move back.
And they got...
They have 1 move.
Oh, well, yeah. They got advantage, too.
Well, that guy doesn't have to move back, actually. Because he's not going to target me. That guy doesn't, because he's not going to target me. He's going to target you.
She's invisible.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But they can move 1, correct?
Yeah. Shit.
Sorry.
Okay, so I'm being targeted by 3 guys, all with advantage.
Yes.
And 2 damage. Base.
Yes.
Oh, this is going to be a bad day.
Let's start with number 1.
Okay, so I will clear these off. Did we kill 6?
Yeah, yes.
Okay, so that's gone. So number 1.
Well, I think that's going to win.
Yeah, I think that's going to win. Still flip 2. Yeah, that's going to win. So that's 4 damage. Oh, this got bad really quick. Yeah, this got really bad. What's next?
at number 3.
3 damage.
And then number 5.
And I'm down. Or wait, no. 1 hit point. And I have no cards.
Yeah, you would have been exhausted.
Yeah.
I think you can discard 2 out of your lose 2 out of your discard pile and stuff.
But now here's the problem. I have to long rest.
No, you can take short rest.
Oh, right, yeah. I think that's what I'm going to have to do.
Just so you can boogie on out of there? Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
All right, so that was the guards, and I believe they were the last ones. Correct?
Yes, they were.
All right. Anyone doing a short rest?
Yes.
No.
Okay. So it's a random card.
Random.
And I'm not losing a hit point.
No.
Yeah, that's not happening. Woo!
All right, can you hand me the monster?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah, I need to shuffle.
And the shaman also.
Well, shuffle, shaman.
Okay. Nicole, go ahead and select one. Oh.
Say goodbye to your flamethrower.
Bye-bye, flamethrower. It was nice knowing you. And I get all the rest back.
Correct.
Wait, I put... No, I haven't done that yet. Okay.
Sorry, cut. There is an earth element. It is now in waning.
Shuffled?
Shuffled. My initiative will be 99.
My initiative will be 99.
Oh, shit. That means unless Peter can go really quick and hop
and
to take all
also...
the attacks. I could be fucked.
No, you got.
How am I going to take all the attacks with 6 hit points?
Yeah.
I mean, I can try, but it's going to be ugly.
Either that or kill lots of shit. Killing lots of shit is also
killing lots of shit.
It was easy to kill lots of stuff last turn because they were already way down.
And they were grouped
These
up.
Guys are like all full.
Yeah,
they're
all...
And they're kind of spread.
Yeah.
So AE is kind of hard right now. Unless they all have to go super quick.
So what I should really do then is concentrate on gaining XP because we're going down.
No, we're doing pretty good.
And get some loot. Don't forget the loot.
Yeah, like, don't forget, if we lose, like, what's the worst that happens? Like, at least 2 of us are leveling, maybe 3.
Nah, I won't be leveling.
Okay.
I was turned off because
I
was character behind.
Yeah.
Oh, and you've only got a little bit of XP?
Yeah.
Huh.
I haven't been able to use my attacks
because
I've been getting whooped.
So, Tony, you know how fast you're going?
Not very.
Okay, so... I might be able to heal you
that
at the expense of doing anything else useful.
Doesn't seem entirely like a bad idea to me, because it brings them back in. And if I at least make it to my turn, which to be fair, I've got all these that can go, but... That might be the best option. I've got 3 guards, an archer, and a shaman that are all going
to
plunk my ass.
How quick do you need me to go?
Probably pretty quick.
Urgh.
If I mean, within reason. If you can get, like, lower than a 20, that's...
No, can do.
Okay.
And I can get a 20, but it's going to cost... Well,
I shouldn't have said numbers, but that's a different story.
I can get reasonably low, but it's going to cost me something powerful that I really want to use very soon. All right, I'll try this.
Okay, let's see what we're going at. So you're both long resting.
Yep.
I am at a 99.
I am at a 34.
36.
Okay, so I'm actually going before you. Let's see where they go. 70, but plus 1 attack. But negative 1 movement, so if we can get an extra 1 away from them. 9. Oof. And 29.
Ooh.
That's a bad day.
Oh, I think 9's the winner, no?
Yeah, 9's the winner, and he's going to get within both range of 2 of us.
So what's his current draw?
If he can, with plus 1 move. So he goes 3 move. and wants to get in range of two of us.
Hey, Rico?
And
you were at the FAC, right?
I think both Nicole and I are still invisible, maybe?
Go ahead.
Was there something about being able to discard an augment?
Oh, yeah, you get to, you get to, when you do a long rest, you can pick those up as part of it.
Yeah, those are technically...
Those are technically discarded, so you can take them if you want.
Unless can it's you a throwaway. Lose them? Like, as lose them as part of the long rest?
Yeah, it's your choice. If you want to leave them active or not.
Okay.
So I think both Nicole and I are invisible still?
Yes.
Which means that he's only in range of one?
Me.
Is that normally the law?
And...
No.
It would go back.
I'm long resting. I want to lose that.
Oh, so that's
what I was asking. Okay. Like, because I want to lose this. This is what I would prefer to lose all the things I could lose.
For your discard, for your long rest, I get you.
Yeah.
Okay, so back on this. Shaman. He's got how much movement again? I lost track. 3 movement, and he has to get within 3 range of me at least. Yeah, he can do that. 1, 2. So there he goes. He's -1 on attack. So 2 base attack. 3 attack. Okay, bye-bye card.
He's got a bless?
Curse.
Goes into my deck. Correct?
Yes.
Okay, next up we have, I'm at 34, you're at 36,
yep.
So we have the archer. Shit. And there is that one right in range of me.
Attack -1 though, so that's good.
Yeah, attack -1, range +1, gonna mobilize. Yay, that's awesome.
Because of fucking course, right?
Yeah, because yeah, that's what I need right about now. Nice little mobilize action going on. Assuming, well, I will live, but... Get a -1.
Hey, you gotta stop calling for it, man. They're just gonna give you the opposite.
Pretty much.
You're basically just saying, please, please hit me harder.
Yeah, pretty much.
Please, sir, may I have another?
Mm-hmm.
Yay. Okay. So now that that's all done, now it's my turn. Yep. And I'm immobilized. Well, fuck. That means all those guards are going to run right in and wallop my ass with +1 damage.
Unless you can go invisible.
That ain't happening. Okay.
Well, if you summon your decoy.
That was my plan. Now, where do I put him for maximum effect? There's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. So, there's my decoy with its whole 6 hit points. And here's me healing myself for 5. And gaining 2 XP.
You also got 2 XP for your decoy.
Oh, right, thank you.
So you're at 10.
Yep, I need a 10 banger. Oh, you guys don't have them. I've got them. Okay. Awesome. Well, that was a great start. Especially since I forgot to put up my stuff on the screen. So I believe Peter's up.
So, do you still need a heal? Or should I spend my effort attacking? So, I can heal you for 3.
Mm-hmm.
But if I do, I won't be attacking. Or I can move and attack somebody else for 3.
I would take the heal if you could, just because I'm about to get walloped by 3 guards for 3 damage base.
No, you're not going to hit it.
They're going to attack your decoy.
2 of them at least. Oh, yeah. All 3 of them are going to attack your decoy.
3 will attack your decoy, sir.
One or two could kill it. Okay, yeah, attack something.
Okay, do we have any mana left?
We have a
earth mana.
Earth mana.
I can use that?
No, that requires fire.
Hmm? No, this is any of them.
No, that's a fire.
You sure?
Are you sure?
Take a look. It looks to me like it says I can do take
nope,
any
that's
and I'll
fire.
Give a wound.
Nope, that's fire only.
He's right. It's fire only.
Okay.
That's fire only. Your mana bolt isn't any.
Oh, okay. It looked like there's an X through this.
There is.
There is.
It's spend.
Oh, okay. I was thinking that the X was the thing they used to...
No. X is...
Show all
it's a little bit
colors.
Confusing because there's 6 colors. So
okay,
it's like
got it.
There's, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so in that case, I will move to here and attack 3 on this guy.
Okay.
See, is there anything else I want to do? No. Cool. Plus 1, so attack 4 on this guy.
Nice.
So he's down to half. And I'm no longer invisible.
Yay.
Yay? I'd be very happy to stay invisible.
I'm sure you would. Anything else?
That's all.
Okay.
So it's now the guards?
Now the guards. They have -1 movement. So they only move 1.
And they all target your decoy?
Yep. So.
Starting with number 1.
1 damage. Or, sorry, 2 damage. Because they're plus 1 damage right now.
Number 3.
2 damage.
Number 5.
Dead decoy.
You served his purpose.
Job.
Thank you, sir.
Press F to pay respects.
All right, the 99s go.
Uh-huh.
So I recovered these.
Oh, and I'm no longer immobilized.
And I'm healed. And I'm no longer invisible.
It's nice to be able to stay invisible during a long rest.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I was kind of like, you know what? You know what this is really designed for? This is designed for not getting killed while you're getting a long rest.
Yeah. Okay. Can you shuffle the archer?
You got it.
Oh, shit.
So I have one more turn of action, then I'm going to have to rest again.
I'm down to 4 cards.
Make them count.
What are you saying about a rest yourself?
So I've got 3 cards left. I'm about to use 2, so I'm going to take a rest next turn.
Okay, how many are in your deck?
I've got a total of 8. There's 2 discarded. I'm sorry, 2 lost and 3 in the discard pile.
Okay.
And I'm planning to put a couple more in my lost pile soon, so I'm hoping that after the next couple turns you'll be able to give me a reprieve. Or is that card already lost?
It's not lost yet, but it's probably going to be next turn. So you might want to I'll be going slow probably next turn.
Okay, so I will go fast next turn?
Yeah.
Do I have to be close to you?
Relatively.
Okay, then I will just try not to stray.
You can
far.
Be at a little bit of range, but yes. Right.
I think we need to kill that shaman.
Yeah.
We need to kill that archer.
That archer too.
Archer and shaman.
And then we can just farm the guards.
Can you give me only 1 card back from here? Or
only 1 lost card. Oh, okay, so the plan is to give you back the lost card that gives you back all your lost cards.
Got it.
So feel free to blow heavy shit right now and lose it, and then next round get your lost cards back, and then I will give you that card back. So you can do it again.
So next turn you'll give me my lost card back, but I'll have to use my lost card this turn.
This turn or early next turn.
Oh, early next turn?
Yeah, as long as it's gone before I go.
But I'll only have 1 card left, so next turn will have to be a long rest, unless I do...
A short rest.
I'm going to have to do a short rest.
Which is kind of okay, because you will get the...
Oh wait, you're right next to me right now, right?
Yes.
Don't worry about that. I'll get you your cards back this round. So I'll get you your discarded cards back this round, and then I will get you your lost cards back next round. Or
okay.
Your 1 lost card back next round.
Okay, that sounds good. So I'll have to use that card early next round. Alright, that means I can do this round.
Assuming I survive. this is an assumption.
Yep.
Okay, I'm good. How are you guys looking?
I'm good.
I'm good.
I'm at a 37.
20.
I am at a 27.
How you looking, Rico? 54. 30 on the guards. That's not good for me. 8 on the shaman. Really not looking good for me. What does disarm do?
Attack.
I can't.
Can't attack.
Oh. Shit. And archers at 14. Yeah, this
is. Oh, shit.
It was nice knowing you.
Yeah, that's
how
that's
many, how many hits can you actually take?
I have 6 hit points.
And how many cards in your hand?
2.
Okay. So anyone beat a 14? Or my fault. Anyone beat an 8?
No.
No.
What's what is our shaman doing?
Move, attack minus 1. So it's me, I presume. Well, no. Who's lower initiative, me or Nicole?
I'm further away than you are.
No, we're both 3.
Oh, yeah. I'm 27, so he hits me.
He hits you for a negative 1 and will disarm you.
What does a disarm do?
That's really bad.
Yeah, that's really bad.
That's super bad.
You are disarmed.
Well, that kind of fucks everything up.
No damage.
No damage?
No damage, okay. But you're disarmed.
Well, shit.
Next up, we have archers at 14. Anybody beat that?
No.
That looks like it's on me. Yes. Of course, a plus 1. So, 3 damage.
Is it a stupid trap again? I can't read the text.
Yes. Adjacent closest enemy. No, wrong spot. There.
Alright. Next up.
30? Anybody lower than a 30?
Yes. Yeah. I'm 27.
Yep. Yay!
I'm 20.
You're
20? Yeah. Okay, so I'm casting Frost Armor.
Root.
I'm going to blow this expensive one. So the way this works, it's an attack 3 with range of 4. Target all enemies on the path to the primary target. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep.
Okay.
So and I gain 1 XP for each enemy targeted.
So you get 3?
So I'll do the XP first.
Okay, so number 1, guard number 1.
So attack 3 on guard number 1. Minus 1, so 2 points get through. Attack 3 on this guard. 2x, so it's 6 points.
So he's down to 2. Was hoping he was dead.
The shaman, no damage.
Oh!
You knew it was coming.
Oh, that sucks.
But we did down one guy, right?
Nope.
No.
Oh, we didn't down anybody?
No, no.
Shit.
They're almost dead. They're both down to 2.
Fuck, well, I ain't doing shit, so.
Oh, yeah, you're up next, aren't you?
Yep. And I can't do shit. I was planning on going all fucking in, and I can't do shit.
Oh.
So does disarm just prevent attacking for a turn?
Anything yeah. That says
cannot attack. Remove at end of turn. How's your hit points looking?
They're not too bad. I mean, but I only have 6 hit points, so, you know, being at full doesn't mean all that much to me.
Can you move in the way?
I'd like to reiterate, 6 hit points.
Ah, fair.
I mean, yes, I'm in better shape than you, don't get me wrong, but...
If you could move here, it might help. You'll at least take 2 of the blows, to my, and then I get 1 and we both might live. Now, to be fair, I'm gone next turn. But...
I'll use the mind's weakness, and then...
Looting's not bad, either.
What am I gonna fucking loot?
Yeah, there's nothing to loot. Yeah, not making that.
No.
What was your move?
2.
Maximum of 4.
Mm.
Could have made it.
Yeah, you can make it over here and loot next turn.
Yeah, but...
Okay.
And the guards.
Now the guards go. Okay, number 1 versus Nicole.
I can take that back. Thank you.
I notice how she's giving it back to me, like I'm the one who caused this. Oh, that's bad. That's 3 damage.
Gonna get me killed. Congratulations.
You didn't have to listen.
Yeah?
I know.
Number 3. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Might be a good time to discard a card.
That's 6 damage. Yeah. Or 4 damage. Or wait. Oh, shoot. Only 2 damage because they're negative 1 on attack. So you only took 2. My bad. And this one would be 4. Or is it... So that was plus 1 before. So this is actually only 2 damage. For the times 2.
So I only took a total of 4 damage.
You should have taken... Yes, 4.
And I'm still alive. Still and I got to discard a card.
Oh, and that'll get shuffled. And now the one on me. No damage.
And what's your movement?
Plus 1.
Total.
Oh, 3. Oh, I'm going to get another one.
You are.
He stops. Oh, the back guy still has to move. Okay, so I get one more attack on me.
Number 2.
No damage. I'm a lucky son of a bitch.
No. You're just lucky she listened to you. I would let you die and picking up loot.
Yeah, you would have. Okay, so who's up next?
That'd be me at 54.
Or I'm 37.
Nope, then you at 37.
Okay, so keep forgetting to switch this. Sorry about that. Get into the game, all that good fun shit. Okay, so kill 2 guys or hit the shaman?
I would kill the 2 guys because the shaman regenerates. Unless all of us are pounding on the shaman at the same time, he ain't going down.
Kill 2 guys and really wound a 3rd. Yeah.
Killing 2 guys and wounding a 3rd seems to me like a great way to do that.
Oh, or I could hit the shaman and the archer. But I probably won't kill the archer. Unless I get really lucky.
Kill 2 to 1.
Okay.
Kill and wound.
Okay, so I'm going to Ink Bomb. I create Dark Energy. And I do 4 damage on... Ooh, it's a ranged attack.
So it would be disadvantage. It'd be first.
Which I don't want to do.
Well, can you target this guy?
No, it's if the guys are next to me. The other 2 would be next to me. So I think I'm just going to go with the original plan and hit these 2. Or I can hit these 2. What do you think? Start wounding the archer or kill this guy?
You kill him, he's just going to spawn a fresh one. But it's far away, so that's not bad.
Yeah, which might be better for us right
now. Yeah, killing him slows down the incoming attack.
Okay, so I will hit the shaman and this guy. Okay, so rather than take the disadvantage. Okay, so hitting the number 3 guard first. Oh, my own deck. Plus 1. So that's 5 damage. He's dead.
Okay.
And I gain an XP.
How many we killed so far?
9.
And now for the shaman. Oh, son of...
Yeah, that's not even the curse either. That's just a regular old gnome.
Wow, that shaman's just like completely like resistant to strong attacks. What the fuck's up with this? Me and you probably could have killed him if it wasn't for us both pulling an ult. Well, shit. Well, at least I get an XP for him. Okay, and I give you back all your discards.
So these. Awesome, thanks.
That's me.
Alright, who between 1, 2, and 5, any of them wounded?
Yes, 1 is down to 2 hit points.
This guy's wounded. Everybody else looks like they're at full.
Yeah.
Except the shaman who's down 1.
Nope, he's full.
He's full. Okay.
And the thorns do 1 damage to me, right?
Yes.
Damn it. I was hoping one of those would be dead already.
Oh, one of those guys over there? Yeah.
Count. 1, 2, 3, 4. But, okay, I can do it.
Oh, yeah, you got your boots.
So I'm going to use the bottom to move 4 with my boots for a total of 6. And then I'm going to attack 1 and 2 and attack 3.
Okay.
So number 1 is attack 4.
Okay, he is dead.
And Nomar 2 is also at attack 4.
He is half down.
I get 1 XP.
And we get another kill marker. That puts us up to 10, right?
Yeah. So we're halfway done.
Do you feel a little bit more than half done?
I think it's mostly going to be up to you at this point. You still get to cycle through your deck again.
All right. I think I was the last one, correct?
I believe so, yes.
Anyone doing a short rest?
Nope.
All right. The elven retreat goes down.
So are you still going to have a chance to give me back my...
I should be able to give you back your card. But okay. Are you going really fast or relatively fast?
If I need to, I can go really fast.
Go really fast.
I'm going to go really fast.
Because I'm worried about them hitting me.
They won't hit you. Most of them, no.
Two of them. Well,
two, maybe.
This one will, and that one, depending on initiative.
Yeah. But the one with a hard enough hit could take me. And I need a shuffle. I'm on. By the way, I'm done after this. This is my last round.
So mega count. I'm ready.
Giving him longevity is mostly what this is about.
I'm set.
I'm ready.
Oh, where did I kill the guy? Did
we put it down? I already put it down.
Okay.
It's sitting right between the three of us. And no, I'm not going to loot Ninja, probably.
Probably.
No, I can't loot Ninja if I'm giving you your lost card. It's in the movement space.
Appreciate that.
Okay. So, I'm going at an 18.
15.
14.
7.
Nice.
Well, we are fast bastards.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
Shield, they're not attacking. They're retaliating at 15.
Plus, they do have shields. I should have saved my bow.
Ah, well, it's only if you go after them.
Yeah.
Shaman is doing his immobilized attack, going at an 8.
Which is...
Wow.
Slower than Peter.
Yes.
And 44 on the archers with extra attack.
All right, Mr. Peter, I think, is winning with the 7.
Yep.
All right, so I'm going to be using this to recover all my lost cards.
Do you get anything for doing the darkness, or does that add darkness?
Oh.
Oh, yes, that adds darkness.
You can't recover that.
What?
That card?
It's gone.
No, you don't recover it yet.
No, you can't.
Why?
It's got that lost forever consumed.
Oh, shit.
Doohickey.
Oh, yeah, so I can't recover that one. Okay, so we'll figure out in my turn.
So, bummer, but. Probably. Oh, well.
So, it does give a darkness, though, right?
Yeah, it does give a darkness.
You didn't get those lost cards back yet, by the way. Oh, you know, you used yours.
I'm going now.
Okay.
So, I'm just now spent.
Okay, that. So one of you is going to get a lost card back, so figure out who it is.
She's got the most down, right? I'm only down 2.
I am effectively down 2. Yeah.
So, whoever has a really powerful lost card.
I could get back my summon.
Now, since I'm spending the top half of this, the bottom half of this I can spend with a heal. Is there somebody who'd like to be healed?
What's the range on it?
Range of 1.
Oh. Well, then.
So I can heal you, Tony.
Not useful.
Not useful. You might want to use it for a reposition.
Yeah, the only thing I can do is move.
Yeah, that might be useful.
Although, you might go heal him. He's going to... It might allow him to take another hit.
No, I'm not going to get hit. I will not get hit because guards are going to shield up and the shaman's going to attack somebody else. Mm-hmm. And then the archer goes last, which would attack one of you anyway. So I'm not taking any more wounds. I would reposition and maybe grab that gold.
So maybe I'll just loot.
Yeah.
Yeah, the only thing I can get back are one of those. They're not the greatest, so if you got something
I'll take bring back my rat horde.
That could come in handy, especially down.
Because you can bolt back anyway. So.
Huh?
You can bolt back, right?
No, yeah, only one.
Only one.
Oh. Okay, so now...
Shaman.
Shaman goes. Negative 1 movement, attack 0. He has to be in range, so he's going to move back. But he won't go into the trap. And that's all of his movement, I believe. That would be all of his
movement.
But
he wouldn't move anymore anyways.
Yep. And now he attacks... Who's lower initiative, you or Nicole?
That would be me. But yes. He was closer. He focuses on him.
Oh,
first,
yeah. He focused on you.
And then backs up
to
so
shoot
that he can
you.
Get the range.
You're right. So attack plus 0. So he's a base 3 attack. And he's going to immobilize.
Bastard.
Oh, shit.
And just 3 attack. On you. Next up, we've got the guards, I believe, unless somebody's faster than the 15.
I am a 14.
Okay, and you're a 15, so both of you will go first.
So I am invisible.
God damn it. You should just put the goddamn immobilized then.
Well, then I couldn't attack, though. You can still attack with the immobilize, sadly. And then I'm scurrying. I move up.
Scurrying!
And then I attack with a 3 on the shaman. I attack with a 4 on the shaman. Oh, shit. That reminds me. I wanted to poison him.
Okay, so 4 and poisoned.
Yes.
And that will prevent him from healing until, like...
The poison clears.
Until, like, the first heal will hit the poison instead of...
That's very useful.
Yeah.
What number is he technically?
2.
Okay. Well, that might change up what I do. Okay, who's up next? Rico.
Me. I will attack at a 4.
Okay.
Attacking guard number 2 for 3.
I'll leave him with 1.
But he is stunned.
He is stunned.
I get 2 HP. 1, 2. This is lost. And I am doing the bottom part of this one to activate my shield for the next 6 attacks.
Oh, nice. Okay.
That's it for me.
Okay, question. Would you rather get the card back or have me kill the shaman? Can I kill the shaman?
Shit. If you can kill the shaman, that's...
Nope. He's out of range of me, isn't he? Range 2.
Yeah, he's out of range of you.
So I could do 5 damage to something and heal somebody, or I can attack and poison something and give somebody a lost card, and give Nicole her lost card back. Oh, you're out of... No, you're in range, barely. Yes. So I can either give Nicole that card back and attack and poison something in short range, or I can heal and do massive damage.
Well, I don't think we're going to get the 20 mark.
Either way, I get 2 XP, so that doesn't play a factor.
It's really hard to say. I don't know how much the rat swarm is actually going to be able to do.
How are you doing on hit points, Rico?
I am currently 3 out of 10.
I think our best chance of hitting the 20 mark might be to have you up.
I think at this point we start thinking about collecting as much loot as we can. But that's just my opinion. Because we're only halfway.
And we are?
We're all going to be out pretty soon.
Except for Peter. Peter will have a bit longer.
Yeah, I've got a little bit longer, but that just means the last turn they'll all be concentrated on me.
Yeah, more or less.
Unless I run away and go for loot.
Yeah, if you're going for loot, do we want to run and open other rooms?
No, I would...
That'll spawn more enemies, which means we'll die quicker.
Mm.
Correct.
Fair. Although there is a treasure chest over there. Maybe one of these rooms has one. I'm betting it's this one.
That would make sense.
Yeah.
It would also be a good time just to do open doors, just to scout.
Oh.
We'll more than likely have to come back here. So if we can find the room with the treasure chest, we know where we need to go.
Yeah. Okay,
If we're going to concentrate on looting, I think we heal.
Yeah.
That way we can take the hits longer. Open doors and all that good
stuff. Should I heal you or Nicole?
It don't matter.
He's the priority. I'm invisible. They can't hit me this turn, and I can heal myself.
Okay, I'm healing you for 4. And I'm attacking 5 something.
Within a range of 2.
3.
3.
Or 2.
Okay.
So, it has to be him.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. That is a dump. Gain 2 XP. And plus 1. Attack 6. So he's down to 2 hit points.
I thought we'd already decided that we weren't going to be able to clear this
shit. It'd still be nice, though.
Yeah, it would be.
It clears the path.
And I'm going to blow my minor stamina potion just to take this in case I end up taking a hit from something.
Okay. So...
I don't think I can take a hit, but just good habit to think about.
So is it now the archer, I guess?
Well, I was 18. Anybody slower than me?
It would be the archer.
Oh.
The one and only archer.
And
so
he's going
to shoot you.
Yep.
And he will hit you for... Shit. Two.
So he hits me for one.
No, two.
Well, he's got a shield up.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. And did you didn't get your XP yet?
No.
Okay. So now it's the turn?
Yep. And I am gone.
Shuffle.
So next turn I'm planning on blowing an attack to hit all four of these guys.
Oh. That'd be good.
I will probably take out two of them.
Yeah. Okay, I need a shuffled guard deck. Oh,
and you
shit.
You need to shuffle yours, Peter.
I do.
The stun goes away on the one guy. And these are long gone. I just forgot to clear them. We don't get our quest thingy unless we win.
No, you totally get the quest thingy if you lose.
This?
I'm fairly sure.
Oh. As soon as you remember during the very first battle that we lost, we got to keep them.
Oh, I think you're right. That would make sense. Okay.
Of course, maybe somebody will post in the comments, yeah, you shouldn't have kept it then either.
Yeah, pretty much. That never happened to us. People love us. We're actually getting quite a few views for us on this. I think we're getting, like, about 300.
No, we do have to successfully complete the scenario. It's just if you're dead, you're fine.
Oh, okay. Completion.
Yeah, you do have to win. Okay.
Where are you guys going at? Oh, Peter's still looking.
Yeah, I've got one card I'm trying to decide what you have that's up. I'll do these two.
61.
11.
25.
50. 62. And 56. But
holy shit.
Attack negative one, target two on the archer.
Okay.
So he'll do one damage to two people.
Alright, so...
you guys got this.
I go first, yes? 11?
Yes.
Okay. So,
What were you at, Rico?
61.
Well, you're going really slow. Wow. You still beat the shaman.
I already moved that down one. Okay, so the shaman is right next to me.
Yes, he is.
He is poisoned. I'm using submissive affliction. That is attack 2, but add 1 attack for each negative condition on the target. So that's plus attack 3, and then plus 2 attack because of mine's weakness. So I'm hitting at a 5, and he's
poisoned for 6.
So it would be a 6 base.
7. He's dead!
Woohoo!
Satisfied by this, by the...
Actually, that's really good.
Ha.
Now open the door.
He only drops 1 loop?
Yeah, it sucks.
Yeah, everything always drops 1.
And I do gain 1 XP from that.
Nice.
And then I use Empathetic Assault and my Boots of Striding. So that gives me a move of 4.
You can open that door or run to the other one.
I'm going all the way to the back. I'm going to open this door.
Okay. You open that door. I need the barrel. I need a guard. Do we have a guard?
Yes.
We need an elite guard.
Oh.
Okay, so we know I'm not to open that door again.
Yeah, that's a bad
need that one closed.
I don't like that door.
He will need 2 more hit points. And he has natural retaliate 2.
Ew.
Oh.
And I need an archer.
Huh.
And an archer.
Ouch.
And it's just normal archer at 6 hit points. And I need a gold.
So I am then going to proceed to back my happy ass up.
Why would you do that?
And then I lose my invisibility. Kind of sucks.
Close the door. Close the door.
Can you close doors?
No. I don't think so.
Yeah, so in any case, that may have been a fatal mistake. Oh, and I heal 2 because of my card. So I got 4.
Alright, next up. 25. 25 it is.
Okay, so this is the attack 3 at range 4 that goes through all the enemies in the path of the primary target. So it'll be 1, 2, 3. I'll attack this guy, and all 4 of these get attacked at 3.
So number 2.
So first number 2, plus 0. So 3 points.
Dead.
Another one bites the dust. This guy, 3 points. Plus 1 becomes 4 points.
I'll get him. There you go. Oh, don't worry about it. You got enough of those. And now next one.
This one. Attack 3, minus 1 becomes 2 points, but that's just what we need to kill him. Another one bites the dust.
So we are at...
And this guy. Plus 1 is 4 points.
13.
So he's down to half.
Wow. That, we might actually win this.
Fuck no. We ain't winning shit.
They're starting to seem reasonable until we open that door.
Shouldn't open the door.
Actually, I'm kind of agreeing with that right about now.
How'd you open the door? Don't listen to us.
Well, I also need a plus 10 XP since I get one for everything I went through. 1, 2.
We always kill you. 3, 4. Don't listen to us.
Okay.
Oh, and I also get to move 3. I can't think of anywhere I need to move.
You could run over here and loot.
You can do that one. You can do this one.
This one would be safer.
There's an elite there.
Yeah, the elites are coming that way.
But they'll hit her.
There you're going to get hit by both guards.
Those guards are going to hit you.
Yeah.
They're going to hit me anyway, right?
No.
Okay.
If you go there, no.
Loot, here it is. It looks like I've got to... I have to spend a fire to get retaliate to.
Yes.
Okay, I think I'm done.
Yay!
The cards are now going.
Okay, so they move 2. Or let's do the elite goes first. Yep. He moves 2. Aw, shitty.
You already fucking counted me out. I can see how this shit works.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't even put me back
in
the same
spot.
Put
you right into the trap. Over and put you into the trap.
4 damage.
Oof.
Okay, then. Now the regular guards go 2 movement.
So number 5 hits me.
Okay. For 2 damage.
So 1 damage. And XP.
Woohoo! And the archer, do we have it? Yeah, we have an archer back.
We have 2 archers.
We do? Ah, shit.
1, 2. So number 1 first.
Number 1 hits 2 people. So who are the lowest initiative of
you
two?
What's his range?
His range is 3. So, 3.
So what's his movement?
He doesn't have to move.
So he's only going to be targeting no one, right?
Or no, I've seen this one. Oh, he goes first.
Numerical order.
Oh, so he moves up the 1. Yeah.
What's his max movement?
2.
So if he moves 2, he can actually turn your
You're
bubble.
Right.
So,
you're
so
right.
That's why I was asking what his actual move number
Sorry, was. I was missing that. So it's going to hit both of you, so we'll start with Nicole. Negative 1 on his attack, so he's only 1 base attack. No damage. Peter. 2 damage.
Okay, I spend 1 of these to negate the damage and gain an XP.
You get negate all of it?
Yes.
Ooh. Any source of damage.
But he can only do it twice, correct. So...
Okay.
So now number 3 will hit.
Who's the lowest initiative of you? Or who's the...
I was 11, so...
Those 2.
I was 25.
So it's both of you again. So Nicole, no damage. Peter, no damage.
Okay.
I'm not going to complain about that.
My ass is dead next turn, I'm betting. Because I've got a long rest.
Oh, shit. Well, you could do a short.
No.
All right. Get some XP here. I'm going to attack 6. Attack 12 on number 5.
He is very dead.
That gets me 2 XP. 1, 2. That is a loss.
And put 1 more over the dead.
Yep, 1 more dead count. How much are we up to?
14. So we need to kill 6 more.
Oh, You didn't spawn a guard at the start.
It's because it's still the beginning of the turn. We're still in the round.
That guy moved.
That guy moved.
Oh, right. Yeah, you're right. Moved. You're right. Yeah, because you went after him.
Yeah, because I'm the last one to go.
Okay.
Round,
yeah, you're right.
I think.
Yeah, you are.
Shit, I can't remember.
No, Shaman goes after you. Well, there is no Shaman. Never mind.
Yeah, so now I will move 4 and attack 2. Sadly, it's only going to give me one guy. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, actually, you would cut through the gold rather than over him, but yes.
No.
Oh.
I'm going over him.
Oh, you're going over him.
I'm trampling him.
Ah!
So, it's a move, jump, attack 2, target all enemies, move through. Sadly, it's only one guy.
Ah.
For 2, nope, for no damage, because that's my normal.
Ah! But you do get the XP.
Yes, which is another 2. See? 1, 2, a...
get a blue chip.
And a low level.
Nice.
Nice.
Which was the biggest thing of this whole shebang. All right. That's it for me.
Okay.
Anyone short resting? Mm-mm. All right. So this goes down. It will be the beginning of the round. So number... what numbers we got here? Number 2 tags back in the game.
Okay. Your long rest.
Yep. If I survive... doing a short rest, probably. I can make it to the door.
Oh, you're going to go for the back door?
I'm going to try to make it to the back door, because I think that's where the treasure is. But I want to confirm.
Hoping to actually get the treasure?
No. I want to see what room it's at, so we know where we got to push.
Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so...
I only got 2 cards left.
Okay, where are you guys at?
I am at a 27.
I'm at a 69. I will be going slow.
And they're at a 70.
Oh, guards have
plus,
the guards.
Plus 1, negative 1 movement, so if you're 2 away from them, they can't reach you. And but they got plus damage. And then plus 1 attack and plus 1 range on the archer, going slower than Rico, but not you. One off of going slower than you.
So it's me.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Cool.
But note, if you're within range of the guards, they will hit you for plus 1.
Screw them.
But if you're 2 away, they can't reach you.
Alright, so I am going to do the top one, which is an attack 3, range of 3. 1, 2, 3. Nope, I can't kill him.
You might kill him.
I might kill him. Oh no.
They're both full.
Oh no. Alright, so I'm going to try to...
I can probably attack that guy this turn too.
But he's going to go before you.
Yeah.
I was hoping to kill him so he didn't shoot you. Ah,
unless you get to... oh, did you shuffle your attack deck?
I might get a null. So, nope. I'm going to shoot guard number 6.
Hoping for that plus 1.
At least get maybe a plus 1 out of the deal.
Yeah, if you get the plus 1, you'll be in good shape.
You got the plus 1.
He's dead.
So number 6 is dead.
Sweet.
And I get an XP for that.
You put in our counter. We're at 15.
And for this one, I will move 3. 1, 2, 3, and push 1, target all adjacent enemies.
They're still both going to reach you.
That's fine.
Okay. Do you do any damage?
No.
Okay.
It's just push. That's it for me.
Okay, now the archers go.
Starting with number 1.
Who has...
inside the room.
Yep. That will definitely be on...
Peter?
Mm-hmm. No, Nicole.
The one inside the room is me.
Yeah. The one inside the room is closer to Nicole, so that goes first.
That will be 3 damage? Yes, 3 damage. Now, the other one, who has lower initiative? Peter or... Peter. So this will be on Peter. 4 damage.
I think the frost armor does its job.
And you get an XP out of that.
Yep, another XP.
Yeah, that really did its job, actually. That was a good hit to take that on.
Guards.
By the way, good catch on the I couldn't give him back that card. Mm-hmm. That was really good.
I realized that it probably wouldn't have let him
nope,
do that.
I go before the guards.
Go.
So, time to burn another card. This is an attack 3, range 3, target 3. Gain 1 XP for each enemy targeted and create a fire. So add a fire, please.
It technically so arrives at the end
one,
of your...
1, 2, and 3.
Okay, so let's start with that archer.
Let's see, there's nothing else I can do to buff, so archer first.
Attack 3.
Times 2.
Dead.
Kaboom!
Okay, that was good. Wow. That was worth it alone!
Okay, this guy.
Nothing.
This guy here. Plus 0, so 3 hit points. And I get 3 XP. 1, 2, 3. And now, do I want to summon Mystic Ally or move and grab loot? Why don't I summon Mystic Ally?
Okay.
And does he attack this turn?
No.
But he'll take the hit.
He'll take the hit.
Because he goes to 4. Three. Yeah.
And he'll take the hit from Nicole for the guard.
Yeah. Correct. Nice. How many hit points does he have?
2.
So he's not going to last very long.
But he lets you survive a round.
Yeah. Without discarding.
So how many kills are we at? Is that 15?
16?
16. We need 4 more.
So we're on to the guards. Move -1. So they move 1.
Elite first.
Oh, yeah. The elite goes first. He attacks +1, so he's got 4 attack.
No. Bye-bye, summon. No.
Nope. So. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, summon.
It was nice knowing you.
Thanks, Seven.
Thanks, Mystic Ally.
I'll light incense to your...
Technically, you could move him here. That'd be better for you.
No,
because anyone's just going to come in right here anyway. So.
Okay.
Doesn't really matter.
Okay, so which one's going first? Number 1.
Number 1.
+2. That would be 5 damage.
Ooh. That's 4. I'm going to activate my heater shield, and hopefully they don't kill me.
And that would be 3 damage.
So I'd have to lose 2 out of that deck, right?
Yep.
Oh.
How many do you have?
4.
I got 4.
So your last turn's coming up. Can you get... Yeah, you can get to the door. So can you attack and then get to the door?
Here.
I keep forgetting to switch the players on the screen. My bad.
Alright.
That's it.
Not least. That's everybody.
Yep.
So number 4.
So you get your cards back, and you heal 2.
Got 1 card left. I can do a short rest or a long rest.
That comes away. It's my last round.
Probably do a short rest.
Short rest, because if we kill 4 guys between 3 of us,
good luck with that.
We win.
All right, Rico. Yeah, I'll take that.
Oof.
I have 3 cards left, so I have 2 more turns total.
My actual last round. Will be it.
Because I could do this, take a short rest, and discard then do it again, a card, and then do it again.
You're right. Oh, and that shaman's long dead, so I'll remove that. Wow.
Alright, I'm good.
Oh no, I'm sorry, I have 1 left because I forgot to discard the summoned Mystic Ally.
Oh.
Your last round too, huh?
Yep.
My last round too.
Two-ish.
All right, so I'm going to try to kill, because we can kill 1, maybe 2 this round. You just got to kill 2 dudes, and we win.
Don't forget your 2 hit points.
The biggest problem is that, like, I can't kill this guy, because the retaliate, I can't kill him.
Can you at least move this way?
Yeah,
try to kill some of these? Maybe? HP, you got 8.
8.
Shit, well, I got 8.
Yeah, it might just be best to open the door. Well, I don't think we're going to get 4 more guys.
Might be able to take that guy out, but I can't do much to the elite.
So you think that you can take this guy out?
Well, if I get lucky.
Can you kill guys, Rico?
I can kill maybe one.
Yeah, I think.
But then I wouldn't be able to open the door.
Okay. I think we're SOL.
This guy, I just have to get.
You only need two.
Not
moves.
Unlucky.
Oh. Yeah, I can still open the door and maybe. No, I won't kill somebody, but.
Do good damage.
I'd do decent damage so someone else can finish it off.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not going to have another turn to finish it off.
You can do it.
It's all on Nicole. Nothing big.
I can maybe severely move wound this number
Oh, don't
two.
Forget you have your movement boots to help you get away, too.
I know.
And yeah. I can maybe wound him. Or this guy.
I'd do the one closer to her. Okay, what are you guys going at?
7 here.
27.
32.
And our guards are going at 30.
Shit, I might not make it.
Negative 1 attack.
Don't matter.
I know. And our archer is going at 32. With extra attack. So 7. Peter, you're up.
So I think I'm going to try and kill that archer and then grab some loot.
Okay.
See, is there anything else I could do? I could do 2 attacks.
Both ranged?
They're both ranged.
You
only one of them has a range of 2.
Fire.
We do have fire, don't we?
It will only do... You can only do one of those with fire. Because it'll drop to inert if you use it, so you can't consume it on both of them, but you can choose one to consume fire on.
Okay, why don't I consume fire on this one, which will give me attack plus 1 and an XP, and then I'll do that, and then I'll decide whether to use the second one as an attack or not.
Okay.
So first attacking that guy at a base of 3, plus 1, 4. He
Dead
is
archer.
Down. And I could. Oh, and 1 XP.
And the fire is spent.
What's the range on that other one?
The range on this other one is 2.
And it does 3.
No, because I'm using the bottom half of the card attack.
So it does 2.
So I can do 2 points of damage to him, or I can go grab some loot. Do you think there's any point in doing damage to him?
I don't think we're going to kill him because
no.
Melee and retaliate.
Okay, then I'm going... Well, he can't retaliate on distance, right?
Correct.
But he can for Nicole.
Yeah, and Nicole's mostly going to be it.
I'm fucking running.
I think, boo-hoo, I'm going to grab the money and run. And I'm spent.
Okay.
27.
Okay.
Do it. We need to find the treasure. Treasure.
Okay,
I can see your priorities. Your priorities are in line.
Because I'm not going to make it past 3 guards. Because they go before me.
Oh, you aren't?
No, I got 1 hit point, no cards.
I'm going to Boots of Striking and use Fearsome Blade. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then it's an attack 2, but it's plus 2, so that's 4.
Roll 2x, 2x, 2x.
So it's just 4 damage. But
still
I get
half
2
dead.
XP. And then... Oh, shit. Oh, well. Doesn't matter now. And then I'm going to use Submissive Affliction.
How much is that attack?
Attack 2 plus 2, so 4.
Oh!
Hold out.
Not the time. Woman, not the time.
But I do get 10 XP.
Woohoo!
Oh, you're at a 10?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Sadly, it's the guards.
Yep, so the leech does move of 3.
Ouch.
Takes a whack on Peter, starting at 2 damage. 4 damage.
Oh, you live.
Okay.
You live.
I was actually at full to start with.
You have to loot again. No, they... Yeah, you can't.
No, he can't.
No,
he's out.
You're done.
Okay, so number 2 is going to... Or no, number 1 is going to attack Rico.
No. I need 3 nulls.
1 damage.
No, I'm dead.
So remove you.
Yeah, I'm dead.
Number 2 attacks Nicole for no damage. And number 4 will move all the way up to Nicole. and attack her for no damage.
Wow.
See, why couldn't that happen to me?
Yeah, no shit.
I could open the damn door at that point.
Yeah, pretty much. And this shuffles.
You are technically exhausted now,
yep.
Sir?
I am technically exhausted now.
Can you do it?
I can open the door.
That's important.
That's all I'll be able to do.
You can't kill three guys?
No. That ain't fucking happening.
Okay. Well, flip your cards.
No, I'm the only one left.
Yes.
So I go at 11.
You go at 11, and all that's left is guards, right?
Yes.
Going at 15. They're shielding
up. They ain't gonna do shit to me.
You might get the treasure chest!
Unlikely. So, yeah, I'm going to start with Empathic Assault, so move 2, heal 2. So, effectively, I get heal 1 for going through the dangerous terrain.
That works.
And then I scurry.
Okay, you still have one more move after that?
Yeah.
Okay. Put 3 traps right in front of the door.
Oh, that's fucking shit.
I don't have 3 traps, so we'll just put 3.
No, if we're out of traps, we're out of traps.
Wow.
You can only place what you can place. Okay. We need 2 archers. We need 1 elite and 1 regular.
Fucking goodbye.
Regular, elite, or move them back 1. Yeah. No. Up 1 there. Which one's elite? Oh. This will be the elite. Just for reference. And we need a shaman. Regular.
Okay.
He's in the back center.
So we need to...
Maybe that elite one over there.
Nope. This is an archer.
Here's a shaman regular. Here you go.
Yeah, see, I thought he was a shaman too. Yeah, there's the shaman.
Yeah.
Oh, he is a shaman.
Regular shaman in the back. Not in the
left. Yes, we take the yellow off.
Matter.
Yeah. 3 golds. The 2 back corners. And right here. And then the treasure chest, right here.
Not right next to the door, huh?
Nope. That would be 5 away from you. And you can go 1 more.
Bam! Yeah, that's the end of my fucking turn.
Wait. So, archers. And shaman.
So 15, 16, then 23. So guards are now shooting.
Guards do nothing. Archers get +1 movement.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they're both in range.
Oh yeah.
But -1 attack.
-1 attack.
So the elite first.
Does he is going to be 2 attack base? Oh, I shouldn't have necessarily shuffled this round. My bad.
So look at you, jumping the gun.
Wasn't expecting the door to open. Oh, wait, no, I was supposed to shuffle. I started shuffling before your turn.
Ah, okay.
Okay, so I did it right. Ooh, 3 damage.
Regular archer.
1 damage.
Shame.
Heals.
Himself?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Whoa!
Okay.
Short rest.
Short rest?
Yeah.
Can you make it to the chest?
Yes.
Woohoo!
Maybe.
If she goes first.
Chest first.
She's got a... It's a rando, so
yeah,
she might
lose her... Yeah, it's
random.
I forgot.
She might lose her high speed.
1 in 3 chance.
What did you do?
I got it.
All right.
Will you go before them is now the remaining question.
11.
Okay. We've got guards, 50. Shaman, 74. Archer, 29.
All right. Can you move the 5?
2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Holy shit, we got the chest. So now we don't need to worry about that next time.
Yeah, so what's the chest?
Well, chest is number 65.
And then I'm gonna fucking die. I'm gonna die so bad.
It was actually, I agree, that was worth it. How the fuck did we pull that out of our asses?
All me! Thank you! 60, thank you!
I said 65? Yes, 65. I need the item deck. From the box.
Now kill three more guys. We won't have to do this dick dance again.
I think this is her last turn.
Is this the item deck?
Yes. Are...
What numbers?
No, I need the red item deck, it looks like. Maybe.
No, the red item deck is the actual items, I think.
It's number 105.
No, yeah, so that'd be a loop.
Items. Or was it 105 or 107?
Random item is blue.
Yeah, this is not random.
It's not random?
Item 107.
Oh. Okay.
I don't know why he told you to grab the item deck.
Yeah,
he just told you to grab 107.
Yeah.
Is what he should have said.
Ah, there we go.
107.
Yes, this is it. Horned Helm. After moving three or more hexes on your turn, add one to your melee attack. It does not tap. It does not discard.
Add it to the first.
Yep.
Wait, I specifically get the item out of it?
You looted it.
You looted it.
Oh,
it's yours.
Wow.
But you cannot equip it.
Can she give it to another character, or does she have to keep it?
I have no idea. I believe they're stuck to the character.
It should be to the character only. But
yeah.
Who knows?
Because your items and stuff all go away when you retire.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe that's stuck, but we'll have to check.
She could sell it, and someone could buy it.
Correct. And you get half price, I believe.
Yeah, you'd have to sell per
or price. When she retires, it would immediately go back into the shop as well.
But now, let's actually play it out here, because you do a heal 2 and you get an attack, no?
Yeah.
Attack 1.
So I'm assuming you did move first, and then you're going to be attacking the chamois, or did you want to move the 3, attack dude, and then move the 2 and self-heal?
I'll attack the chamois.
Okay.
I deal 5 damage to the... 5 damage to him.
Okay, so
you're
he
down
had...
To 3.
No, oh, no, 4. He left 4 left. Oh, no, wait, he's a regular.
No, he's a regular.
He has 1 left.
Yeah. So
how much do these elites have?
The elite has 8, and the regular has 6.
Alright, any XP for all that movement stuff, little lady?
Nope.
Alright, so they're gone.
Okay, so first up we have the
archers.
Elite archer goes first. He has -1 attack. So, 3 base, 2. And I think you're dead.
Nope. She takes 2.
Oh. Then we have the basic archer. No damage.
Alright.
Shit.
Now we have the
guards. But you are mobilized, it looks like.
Guards move 2. Yeah, she's immobilized now.
Ha ha. You can't fucking get me. Ha.
And now the shaman is move -1, doesn't matter. Oh, yeah, he needs to move 1 away and does an attack of 4.
Yeah, that's probably it, right?
Whoa.
4.
Yeah, that's it.
Technically speaking.
Oh, well, then you can't.
But now you're dead.
But yeah, I'm dead.
Yeah, so either way, it's good run. We got the loot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Woot! Damn it, I didn't. Got check marks.
All right.
Yeah, I would have gotten my check.
I had to have short rest, so I wouldn't have gotten mine.
I was told don't take, or take only short rests.
Oh, wow. Yeah, mine was take only long rests.
Wow.
Mine was to use all of my equipped items. I have to use at least 2 more than my level.
Oh,
and I used exactly 3, so that's why I used the bow, though it didn't help in the slightest.
What was yours, Chief?
Oh, mine was so goddamn easy this match. Aggressor, have one or more monsters present on the map at the beginning of every round during the scenario.
Wow, that
would have, if we would have just killed 3 more guys.
And how many checks?
2.
Oh!
That would have been 2 check marks.
Okay, so we straight up just gained the experience that we had.
So I get 6.
And the gold, right?
Yes, and the gold. I just didn't have any gold, so.
We get no bonus gold.
It's times 2.
Oh, times two?
Yes. So whatever you collect times two.
Okay, so I get eight. So, are we going to hang out here or go back to town?
We're going to town because three of us need to level.
Ah, are we going to, do we have to do a road event to go back to town?
No.
Okay.
It's apparently safe going in the other direction.
Are we going to do a town event before we head back?
No, we head back first. Once we reach town,
then
automatically level.
Okay.
If you have the XP to level, you must level.
Okay, cool. And if you have three check marks, you get to do that as well.
11.
So, Peter, are you leveling?
I am leveling.
Okay. So everybody gets to pick one of their number two cards to take out of their available deck.
And then I have to replace that.
You can replace. You can replace. You don't have to.
But I mean, I can't add it to suddenly have my hand size go up.
Yep. Yeah.
That's your choice.
Then you can get rid of something else to put in that nifty level two or not.
And there's two level twos to choose from. For those at home that were wondering, I personally chose the stamina booster for mine last time. I don't know if I mentioned that on the stream. And for mine, I also chose, for my two perk options, I took the remove two negative one cards, which obviously did not help me very much because I kept drawing that negative one card that remained.
Ooh.
Yeah, they're pretty good. And don't forget to look at the initiative value. That can be a factor.
Force one normal or elite enemy within range 3 to perform its turn this round as if its allies were enemies and its enemies were allies.
Oh, wow. Yeah, we need to look up that shaman, because a lot of the others say heal self. I wonder if heal means it only heals something else.
Nah, he can heal himself. It's he didn't have an option to heal himself, he'd probably heal something else, my guess. But we ought to check the rules, you're right.
Oof.
So I've got two cards here. One, the discard lets me attack 7 hexes.
Holy shit!
And the other is a nice attack 3, range 3, that I never have to discard and always generates light.
Oh, that's a hard call. It's, 3 attack, range 3?
Yeah.
And how much damage is the other one, the 7 hex?
It's an attack 2, range 3, but it also does muddle.
Nice.
2 XP and an ice.
Oh, wow.
But I have to discard it.
Yeah, that's a hard call. And then what's the bottom effects? Are they worth considering?
The attack 7 is a heal 6, but it's also a discard to heal 6.
Okay.
And it's just a move 4
and
on the other
one. And what's
the
range on the heal?
The range is 2.
Okay. The other one's a move 4?
Yeah.
That's a hard call. Yeah. Personally, I would take the reusable one.
Yeah, I'm thinking of going
just
for the reusable one.
The other one is always a discard, and that's risky.
Right, but remember I've got the recover all my discards, or recover all
my lost. Yeah. That actually does help.
It does.
Yeah. Oh, that's a hard call.
The other option is an upgraded summon.
Oh, and you can bring both.
I know.
What's the bat? Oh, wow. 4 hit points, 3 movement, 3 attack?
Yeah. It doesn't do the poison like my other one, but...
Wait, and you can curse enemies?
Yeah.
If you have...
Dark.
Which I generate dark.
I also can generate dark, theoretically.
Oh, yeah. So even if you don't summon, you can curse, which means we put the additional no attacks in their deck.
This is an attack 2, range 4, immobilize. And then the other one that allows me to
force and you get XP if you can spend ice.
Oh.
And what does the bottom thing do?
It's not spending ice. It's I create ice and get XP.
Oh, okay.
The bottom is the one where it's basically like force an enemy to perform its turn as if enemies are allies and allies are enemies.
Oh, that is a hard call. Now you can take the other one when you hit level 3.
I know, but the level three ones are good too.
How about you, Rico? What'd you go with?
I went with Juggernaut. Move 2, attack 2 for the top ability. Returning bed, and the bottom one is on the next 3 sources of damage to you, suffer no damage instead. 3 times.
So his with an extra, and it gives you 3 XP.
Yes.
Okay, and what are you doing for your perk?
Removing 2 negative 1 cards from mine.
Yeah, that seems like the best call to me.
Well, I always remove negatives, they get a chance.
Mm-hmm. Also, it makes your deck smaller, but that means you might hit your null more frequently. But no,
I'd rather just get rid of the negatives.
Oh, no, no. Take those cards, go into your personal package. Into this little thing. Reason being is, if you put on, like, the armor that adds two negatives, those can be part of that.
It's 10:30. Are we doing more?
We'll decide after we hang up.
All right,
so first, let's finish up with leveling, and we'll do the town event just to get that done.
No,
okay,
no.
I think I'm
going
to take the reusable one
here. We
should
do that beginning of the next turn.
You think so? Oh, okay.
That's part of the next thing. No?
Okay, and Peter, what are you doing for your perk? Or what did you decide your card?
I decided to take the reusable one here. So it's attack 3, range 3, and get an energy every time, or a move 4. But it's completely reusable.
Yeah, the move 4 is
nice. Yeah, the move 4 is going to be nice. How about you, Nicole? Still deciding? So you took the perk of remove 2 negative ones?
Yes, well. But,
it's not always the right answer.
I know, but like, I mean, I like some of the other options, but...
Yeah.
I mean, like, add 2 plus 1 keep pulling cards?
Yeah.
I mean, those are kind of nice. This is a loss. That's a loss. Ugh. I'm going to take Hostile Takeover.
Okay, so Hostile Takeover is, as you see here, that's the one she's talking about that can do a whole bunch of fancy shit. There you go. And Peter, have you decided on your perk?
Yes, my perk is going to be a plus 2 fire card. So it's plus 2 to damage, and
you create fire.
I create fire.
Oh, here. Okay, sure. So that's the card that he's putting in. There you go. Nice. Okay, well, thank you very much for joining us. And unfortunately, we only did one session. We're not planning to do another one right now. If something changes, you'll find out next week when it goes up suddenly online. But so we probably won't be back for 2 more weeks. And games are taking longer than we were told, so I think we're mostly just playing this every 2 weeks and doing one session, barring, of course, like some holiday or something where we have time off and feel like we can blow it.
Yeah.
So thank you very much for joining. And one thing we'd love to know is let us know if the hit point tracking, if that was something that you liked, being able to see it directly on the units and being able to watch that more clearly, or if you'd prefer us to use these boards and the hit point tracking on there in the future. We'd love to hear what you think about that. Thanks very much.